on the clock. Players looking in, still the rock. Let the defense line them up. QB trying to pass them up. Come on! The fans and mascots are on deck. College football Saturday is on next.
Nebraska quarterback Jamal Lord knows this is the biggest game of the year, especially after what happened just 2 weeks ago, the bitter loss at home against the Texas Longhorns. Big 12 Conference Football and College Football Saturday, presented by Kia Zara, welcomes you to the Little Apple. And what a matchup with the number 11 ranked Kansas State Wildcats taking on the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Big game as well for Kansas State, a win today at home and a loss later. Colorado facing Iowa State on Fox Sports Net, a virtual tie for the top spot in the Big 12 North Division standings. Hi, everybody. Joel Myers alongside Dave Lapman. Welcome to Manhattan. Well, Dave, it's only a two-hour drive from Lincoln, Nebraska to Manhattan, Kansas. It used to seem like 12 hours, though, for the Wildcats, and now, well, they feel like they can make it in 90 minutes.
And the reason that that distance is getting closer, L. Roberson, for one, this guy's an electrifying, elusive, open-field runner. What he's doing better this year, though, making better decisions, knowing when, where, and how to throw the football down the field accurately. Darren Sproles, 5'7", hides behind those offensive linemen. He's like a custom-built sports car. He gets 0 to 60 as fast as anyone in the country. He's got built-in rack and pinion steering for change of direction. Very special.
Very strange year for the Nebraska Cornhuskers. They try to play the role of the spoiler, and they can accomplish that with a win today and a win next week at home against Colorado.
And the king spoiler could be Jamal Lord, 220 pounds, so he's got deceptive power. He's a long-legged strider, but he's also got those jackhammer feet that can make you miss in space. Also, good play-action passer down the field to his tight ends. Kelsey is back after a 6 weeks absence, trying to heal up that right groin. He still leads the team in sacks, pressures, and tackles for loss. This guy is disruptive. Why? Quick hands, quick feet, low pad level, separates from blocks in the running game and passing game as well as anyone.
Husker seniors try to win for the first time their last Saturday in Manhattan, Kansas. Kickoff just a few minutes away. First, Chris Rose, Kellen Winslow, and Artie Gigantino. Gentlemen.
All right, guys, we'll see you shortly. In the meantime, welcome inside the College Football Saturday studios. I'm Chris Rose, working alongside the Hall of Famer, Kellen Winslow, the coach, Artie Gigantino. We'll hear from those two gentlemen shortly. But first, guys, in 2 years, Iowa has gone from 3-8 to perhaps the school's first 11-win season. That's with a W over Minnesota today. Now, if the Hawkeyes take care of business and get some help from Illinois against Ohio State later on, Iowa, Rose Bowl bound for the first time in 11 years. The Floyd of Rosedale pick up for grabs today, and Brad Banks, a guy that is leading a balanced offense. First of all, Fred Russell right up the middle, and then Banks, perhaps the best in the nation at the play-action fake.
They get the ball inside. You've got to bite on it. They run the ball so well, and Banks able to throw on the move.
That to Dallas Clark for the down to the Minnesota 23. Then Russell capping off that first drive with his ninth TD rush of the year. It's the eighth time in 12 games they have scored on their opening drive. They have just missed a field goal. However, they do have that 7-0 lead, looking to run the table in the Big Ten Conference for the first time ever in school history. And guys, of all the one-loss teams out there, Washington State, Texas, Oklahoma, you name it, Iowa might be the most impressive right now.
Yeah, they're most impressive. Not for that second half against Iowa State where they blew a 21-point lead. This team would be undefeated. They have the longest winning streak already since their loss, and they're playing outstanding football on the, throwing the ball.
And Brad Banks is the leader, obviously, of this football team. 23 touchdown passes against only 4 interceptions. Kurt Ferentz, the head football coach, has done a great job of rekindling the energy at Iowa.
Once again, if Iowa wins and Ohio State loses, they're going out to Pasadena.
Absolutely.
Hey, guys, it took Darren Sproles just 159 carries to reach the 1,000-yard mark. Quickest of any back in K-State history. How much will he get against Nebraska? Find out in minutes. Welcome back to College Football Saturday, presented by Kyocera. Kansas State has scored 166 points in its last 3 games. Nebraska will obviously have its hands full today in Manhattan. Now, the Cornhuskers and Wildcats kick off Big 12 Saturday because later on, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, Iowa State continues its road trip from hell with a stop at Folsom Field. Colorado's Chris Brown less than 400 yards shy of the 2,000 rushing plateau. Last week, Kansas State's defense actually outscored Iowa State's offense, so that's what you're keeping your eye on.
Yeah, Kansas State's defense has been the cornerstone of why this program has become so successful. Number one in the country, Kellen, in scoring defense.
The key for Nebraska today to stop the run. Kansas State is third in the nation in rushing the football, but only 43rd in the nation in total offense. The inability to throw the football will hurt them.
All right, guys, we will see at halftime with all the scores and highlights. But right now to KSU Stadium with Joe Myers, Dave Lapham, and Jim Knox. Guys, have a good game.
Thank you, Chris. Senior day and doing his Ozzie Smith backflip onto the field. Terrence Newman, one of the great defensive backs in the country, one of 27 seniors for Kansas State. Let's head down to the third member of our team, Jim Knox. Jim.
How about that backflip, Joel? That's right. Senior day here in Lawrence, here in Manhattan, Kansas. I tell you what, big factor in today's game, kicking game, and here's the reason why. Two of the best punt returners in college football you'll see today. Kansas State side, Terrence Newman, already one punt return for a touchdown. Meanwhile, on the opposite side, you have Nebraska's DeJuan Gross. Three punt returns for touchdowns this season. One more, folks. And that's an NCAA record. And check out the backflip by Terrence Newman. Senior day in Manhattan, Kansas. Who moved the big play today? We'll find out coming up next.
Magnificent afternoon for football in the middle of the country. Welcome back to Wagner Field. Frank Soltich, his fifth year, 30-plus wins over his first three. A real uneven year, though, as their defense had some problems midseason. They have regrouped. Bill Snyder, he's turned the program around. But still, only 2-11 against Nebraska so far in this, his 14th season. So Jared Bright, the junior from Bakersfield, California, ready to kick it away. As Kansas State won the toss on Seniors Day, but deferred and took their option. They'll have the ball to start the second half. And one of the best kick return men in the country. He's 14th nationally, Josh Davis, the junior from Loveland, Colorado. So we are ready to go, and we're underway on Fox Sports now. Now, what a matchup of the Big 12. Davis on a short one from the 7. Looking for a lane. Cracked at the 23 and driven back. So that's where Nebraska's going to have it offensively at their own 23-yard line with a quarterback who's just become the 18th in NCAA Division 1A history to rush for 1,000 and throw for 1,000 of the same season, Jamal Lohr, the junior from Bayonne, New Jersey. Incognito, Erickson, Garrison, Cody, Villa Waldrop up front with the skill men, Dietrich, Davies, Hasselbrock, Thomas, and Galladay. And what a job this wall has done recently, Dave Lapham. The last three games, Nebraska has rushed for better than 300 yards an outing.
They're chilling up front very, very well.
Dietrich, the single eye back, coming off his first 100-yard game of the year, and up against this defense, he doesn't get a thing. And defensively, this K-State defense in the 4-3 alignment is fourth best in the nation in total defense. Shaw, Reese, White, Bryant up front as the All-Texan trios at the linebacker spot. Hickman, Pierce, and Buell. Who would have said that before Bill Snyder got here? Newman and Jordan on the outside. Walker and Washington are the safeties. Second and 10 on the toss. Against the grain, doesn't make any difference. Play torpedoed on the outside by Andrew Scholl.
Both snaps, Joel. You've had extreme penetration by Kansas State. There's a Kansas State down defensive player, slow to get up, is getting up on his own, Brian Hickman, the linebacker, but he needs help negotiating his way off the football field. Might have gotten kicked by one of those Nebraska offensive linemen. See the penetration. Here's Hickman. Let's see what happens as he goes to the turf. His leg goes airborne, and I think he collides with his own teammate, Buell. I'm not sure it's that bad an injury. We'll just have to wait and see. If he can possibly walk, he'll be back out in the football field.
The young man from Mesquite, Texas. He's only a junior. Nebraska, not in the top half of the Big 12 in the third down attempts. And a third, a little less than 10. Third and 9. Lord, not his strong suit. And the tight end is drilled. He tried to get it to Matt Herrion, their true freshman, who came up with a big grab against Texas to make it a three-point game.
Yeah, Matt Herrion's got three catches on the season. Two of them have gone for touchdowns. He runs the crossing route, trying to settle in a seam between the zone, between a couple of defenders. Can't quite settle at the proper spot, and he takes a big knock from Rashad Washington on the incompletion.
Terrence Newman, back for the punt. Jim Knox just talking about his attributes. He's brought one back for a score this year. One of the best kickoff return men in the nation as well as Kyle Larson, who's in the top 20 in punting. Off the side of his foot, and what a hop for Kansas State. They're going to have it close to their own 43-yard line. So everything working for K-State early, especially their defense, and now the special teams working against Nebraska. Kyocera starting 11 offensively. L. Roberson. He has already topped his rushing total from last year with a couple of games to go. Barnett, Leckie, Washington, Johnson, and Miller up front. And Darren Sproles. What a running back he has turned out to be, the sophomore from Olathe. With Travis Wilson in the backfield as the fullback. And Taco Wallace is their leading receiver this year by a long way with 34 catches. So Roberson, the I formation to start the game.
There's Kelsey right there lining up at that left defensive end spot, and he's offside. He said movement, though.
He said it was movement over there on the right tackle.
He said Miller flinched. Big Miller, Billy Miller, the right tackle, flinched in that three-point stance. Kind of worried about Chad Kelsey, and he did.
Offense, 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
I should say Chris Kelsey, his brother Chad, an All-American and captain at Nebraska as well. One of many, many brother tandems that have played at Nebraska. You talk about up in the bit. This guy's ready to play. You know, he's in great shape. He's stronger. He worked in the weight room the whole time he had the 6 weeks off. He feels he's stronger, and he got great cardiovascular work. But, Joel, there's a difference between being in shape and being in football shape. He hasn't had any contact. He's going to get stiff and sore after this football game for sure.
Remember the first five games, though, Dave, he had 4.5 sacks, leading the team at that point. Fullback Wilson barging his way close to a first down. Too easy on first and 15, and he gets 16 to the 44 of Nebraska. Bella Bland, the rubber back, coming through in the secondary defensively. And this has been a group that's been up and down this year. The 4-3 alignment for Nebraska. Shanley, Rude, and Holloway have been their strong suit. And out of the corners, well, they've got a true freshman starting in Fabian Washington, as well as DeJuan Groves, Bullocks, and Bland, the safeties. But they have been question marks as well. So now first and 10 at the Huskers 44. Sproles. His first carry doesn't net much. Slams it straight ahead for maybe two. Close to the 41.
Sorry, Joe. Kansas State's offense, their philosophy is power running game to anchor Nebraska inside first. This is against any opponent. Anchor you with the inside running game and then spread you horizontally with the option and then go over the top from time to time to stretch you vertically, throwing the football. Right now they're trying to establish that power inside running game.
They're fifth in the nation in rushing, 253 yards a game. It's a second and 8 outside of the 41. Delay, Sproles, not much to get, but they finally knock him down after he tried to slide to the outside. Patrick Kabongo making a nice play, the junior from Montreal. He slides under Kabongo, and it's easy for Sproles to do. He's only 5'7", and he's to the boundary.
Yeah, and Kabongo's 6'6". Kabongo's almost a foot taller. So there's not a whole lot of hitting surface for Kabongo. You see Sproles in the huddle. Sproles, 5'7", 175 pounds, hides behind those offensive linemen. He's hard to find. Built very low to the ground, extremely explosive player.
Let's see if they run the option. They spread the defense with three wide receivers. And problems for Roberson. Can he run for it? He's thinking about it. Reversing his field. What a nice move down the middle. He's got it all the way inside the 20. The extra dimension to L. Roberson, just like Jamal Lord gives Nebraska.
Totally frustrating for a defensive football team. They cover everything in the pass play. Roberson avoids a big defensive lineman, Kabunga. That's an 18-wheeler trying to stay in the open field with the Ferrari, that change of direction. Now you see the elusiveness and the electrifying open field abilities of L. Roberson. Turns nothing into something big.
It's outside of the 16, first and 10. Sproles, Wilson comprising the backfield, and they put Wilson over to the right side. Now calling his own number, it's L. Roberson diving close to another first down. He's got 8 on the carry. We saw that earlier this year from Missouri, the fake, and then the quarterback takes it.
Exactly. It's a little quarterback counter design play. When you have a running quarterback like Lord and like Roberson, you run the quarterback counter, you run the quarterback sweep, you run the option. Back going one way, making the block. L. Roberson going the opposite direction. Back goes left after the fake. Roberson goes right, confusing the Nebraska linebackers, and he hits the crease.
Almost like an unbalanced line, and that's why Nebraska, I believe, is going to call a timeout, and they do. They were top-heavy on the right side.
Yeah, they sure were.
So like Nebraska, we will take a timeout. All K's stayed early with great field position. They are about to capitalize. College Football Saturday on Fox Sports Net, brought to you by Kia Cero. One company, countless solutions. By Nissan and your Nissan dealer. By FedEx, Ground International Online or Express. Don't worry, there's a FedEx for that. And by Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Welcome back to the Little Apple. What a beautiful day for football in Manhattan, Kansas. Joel Myers, Dave Lappin, Jim Knox, and the second highest scoring team in the nation. That's its second and two at the nine of the Huskers. High formation, and they go big. Roberson holds on. He wanted to angle it back the other way. Chopped down just shy of the first down inside the 8-yard line. How about 46 points a game? Will that do it for you?
Man, number two in the country scoring and number one in the country in points given up. I mean, that's you can't get a whole heck of a lot better than that.
So now third and a little less than a yard, Dave. Let's see if they put it on the perimeter and run the option, or will it be a sneak? It's Sproles. He's got it all the way inside the five. Was it a silent count, though, because Nebraska didn't even move?
Yeah, I think L. Roberson, all he did was get his hands on the center and gave the silent count to his center, big Steve Washington. And right now, Kansas State is dominating. It was a three and out defensively. They got the field position advantage with a bad punt by Nebraska and the quick snap. And L. Roberson finds a cavity. I mean, it was like the Red Sea parted. When you're inside the 10-yard line, that's unusual.
He got five, almost six. Now over the top. Is it in? Yes. Touchdown, K-State, L. Roberson.
What he's doing, Joel, on both of those quarterback sneaks, ran right behind the best offensive lineman, Leckie. Leckie is a stud up front. Nick Leckie can play guard. He can play center. And right now, Kansas State's coming off the ball. And look at him knocking Nebraska backwards. This is goal line. And they knocked him into the end zone. You talk about capturing the line of scrimmage. Kansas State had the lower pad level. They got under Nebraska's pads and rolled him back into the end zone. Fine thrust off the line of scrimmage.
Joe Ream in for the point after. They've been anything but automatic for K-State this year. It's down. And it's good. But they have missed a few. In fact, Wright's missed three, Reams missed five, but they didn't miss a thing on the opening drive, covering 56 yards. Wildcats by seven. Took only 4:55 for K-State to get in the end zone, the number 11 team in the nation. And welcome back to Manhattan. L. Roberson diving in on a sneak from 1 yard away. Our Nissan scoring drive. Call it a 55-yard drive as Jared Bright kicks it away once again to Josh Davis, looking up into the sun. And what a kickoff. Oh, he'll stay in the end zone. That'll take the return team out of it. And the guy that's 14th in the nation in returns, Josh Davis.
Well, you saw that touchdown, that quarterback run by L. Roberson, the 42nd touchdown rushing of the season for Kansas State. They're already leading the country with 41. That 42nd sets a new record. Take a look at the Big 12 North Division here. Kansas State battling for their lives. If Colorado, it doesn't go well up in Colorado against Iowa State. Kansas State's got it going.
Offside call, free kick with that flag coming down late. And the Big 12 South you were talking about with Texas. Right now with a 5-1 record, Oklahoma does have the tiebreaker, though, with the win over Texas earlier this year.
Right on. And we've got Oklahoma State, the Saturday after Thanksgiving. How big is that football game?
Well, last year was a lot of fun for us.
Oh, absolutely.
And not because Oklahoma lost, but because it was so well contested.
And Texas has got a battle tonight. They got Texas Tech on the road at Lubbock and Cliff Kingsbury. Working against Chris Sims, what a battle of quarterbacks.
What about 900 yards passing between the two?
Could happen.
It really could. We could see at a game they could put together about 90 points.
Right. It's very feasible.
As good as the defense has been for the Longhorns this year, Kingsbury can throw the football. We know that. Two guys that are phenomenal talents. Davis again will get the opportunity. Now can you take the return game out? You get a chance from near the goal line. set up on the right side, and then slowed down across the 15 and dropped shy of the 20. Great coverage. The K-State special teams owner, Bill Snyder, have been very good for a long time now. Marcus Patton, the reserve defensive back, making the stop. Get a start early on the NFL weekend. Get it started tonight, in fact, with Tommy Davidson of the guys, Tony Siragusa. In fact, Tommy's going to visit the Goose's old stomping grounds in Baltimore. So start it off. It's the NFL show, all presented by the U.S. Postal Service tonight after Iowa State and Colorado, right here on Fox Sports Net. From the 19, Nebraska, the second time they've had the football. Three and out the first time. And Lord with a pretty play fake. Plenty of time, and then a terrible throw at the feet of the tight end, John Bowling.
They did a good job of keeping Bowling tied up at the line of scrimmage. The tight ends in the play action pass from Nebraska always blocked first and then release, and Bowling got grabbed as he was blocking and releasing, and Lord has really nowhere to go at the football. He gets rid of it and gets thumped and throws the ball a little bit low for Bowling, but Kansas State all over it. They read that play action pass to perfection.
Bowling goes over to the sideline hurting. It's Judd Davies. He's in the eye with Darren Dietrich. Lord calling his own number on the late pitch. Dietrich chopped down in the secondary, close to the 24 by Terrence Newman. And a great job by Newman, otherwise he's got a first down on the sideline.
I'll tell you, the thing that you have going on here is both these football teams running the ball. Who's going to make people miss, and what defense is gang tackling? Kansas State is gang tackling, and Kansas State is making people miss.
Jim Knox, what's the latest?
All right, Joe, right now, Brian Hickman, number 18 of Kansas State, linebacker, back in the game. Just like you guys said, leg whipped. He went to the sidelines, checked it out. Everything's okay. He's back.
He's one of those three tough Texans in the linebacking core. Lord for the first down. Low throw, and David Horn can't get there. The true freshman out of Omaha. That is a serious open field tackle.
Bobby Walker.
Yes.
Tremendous job. And that's the thing. Right now, Kansas State's defense is a clinic. And just grabbing it. This is a guy, Horn, in the open field who always makes the first guy miss. Couldn't make Bobby Walker miss. Great effort in the open field.
Terrence Newman. Back for the punt. Kyle Larson. And another wobbler by Larson, a short one. And another hop for Kansas State. What next for Nebraska? K-State's going to have it at their own 39 after starting the last time at their own 45.
That's what a punt return guy does for you. A good punt return guy, you have to directional kick, and you miss hit punts.
And our question, hopefully you'll join us. Log on to foxsports.com on Lycos. Should fans be arrested for storming the field? How do you feel about it? And
that's an interesting question.
Should coaches be down there after games? At least coaches from the booth. In the I formation, Sproles with a hole on the left side. Lowers his shoulder, the little guy. He sure is a charge, isn't he? Sophomore at 5'7", 170 pounds.
And the thing people worried about was durability. He's made a big percentage of his yards right between the tackles. Worry about durability because he's 5'7", 170, but he bench presses 400 pounds. I mean, if this guy were 6'1", you know, he'd weigh 225 pounds. He's just a short man. He's not a midget. He's a short man.
Second and six. I'm not calling him that.
He's a man, I'm telling you.
He's easy. Change at the line. Well, Roberson making the call. Short side field option. And a nice run again by Darren Sproles. Close to the first down, shy by a yard. We'll come right back. Dr. Pepper game break first, though. Chris Rose, what's going on in college football?
All right, guys, from Manhattan to Michigan. Wolverines up 14-0 when Jim Leonard returns the punt 38 yards for the touch to get Wisconsin back into this one. Back out to you guys, and you're watching two of the best punt returners around.
Without a doubt. Thank you, Chris.
Yeah.
And DeJuan Gross and Terrence Newman.
Big time. And I think what we're going to see is a lot of directional kicking, not kicking to those guys because of their excellence. And as a result, you see punters, particularly Larson from Nebraska, he's 0 for 2 all squarely.
K-State. Third and about a yard. It's going to be Sproles trying to go low. And he's real close to the first down, right at the 49. He needed to go across the 49, and it doesn't look like he got it by a matter of just a couple of inches.
That was a good second effort by him, but one thing that Chris Kelce has to worry about or work on, when you come back from injury and you've been off for a while, pad level, you can't stand up. And he stands up, his pad level's too high. And the offensive lineman gets underneath him and knocks him backwards a little bit. Now, you have a situation where that offensive lineman, Billy Miller, has been playing every week. Kelce hasn't. The biggest thing is getting that pad level down. Everybody wants to stand up when you come back from injury.
K-State, 8 of 11 on fourth downs this year, 73%. They'll go for it. What about a quarterback sneak? Yes, he's got it. Well, the quarterback sneak worked that well to begin with, close to the goal line. One time they got six, Dave, and the next a touchdown. Why not?
Yeah, they found some serious cavities in the Nebraska defensive front seven when they were inside the five-yard line. Remarkable cavities.
And you talked about Leckie, and that's where he's going, between Steve Washington, the center, and Nick Leckie, who was third-team All-Big 12
Leckie's
last year, and he's going between his left guard and center.
Yeah, Leckie is the best lineman on the football team. He's the war daddy. He can play center. He can play guard. He comes off the line of scrimmage in an angry state of mind. He's a good football player.
Well, he should have it. They didn't get the spot they thought. It looked like it was close to the 50. They put it between the 49 and the 50. But I still think he's got it by the length of the football.
And you can see Kansas State still establishing that inside power game, Joel, just hammering between the tackles. And then they'll start running the option.
First down, Kansas State.
Once again, the surge at that left side of the offensive line. Leckie comes off, and you look at Leckie's 2 yards down the football. Watch Leckie come off the line of scrimmage, double team, rubs. Look at the surge. Leckie takes his defensive player, the nose guard for the Nebraska Cornhuskers, Bingham, right off the line of scrimmage. Good surge.
You do not have to throw the football when you can run it like Kansas State has done early. It'll be an option to the boundary side, and what a trip by Kelce. If he doesn't get L. Roberson, that's another first down.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, that the coach Bill Snyder and Hudson, the offensive coordinator, Kelce ran it down from the opposite side of the field. So you have to think about reverses. Kelce didn't stay at home. Watch the backside pursuit. Watch him pursue this down the line of scrimmage. Now you have to worry about, fake it and come back the other way, because nobody's staying home up there. But that was a great effort by Kelce to chase it down from behind.
Senior from Auburn, Nebraska, makes the big play after a gain of a couple.
Uh-oh.
And a loose ball on the ground.
Nebraska
Who's got
it?
Nebraska's got the football. Coming up with it,
Hollowell.
T.J. Hollowell, the junior from Copperas Cove, Texas. And the first turnover belongs to the Nebraska, an area that has been really on the bright side for Kansas State this year. Not Nebraska so far this season.
You're right on, Joel. Coming into the game, Kansas State plus 14 in the turnover, seventh best in the country. Nebraska minus 3. But not a contest. They were fighting for the football. Fullback says, I want it. L. Roberson says, no, I want to take it out of there. And the fullback, Travis Wilson, and L. Roberson could not decide if it was a fake or a handoff. And as a result, those guys caused the fumble, and Hollowell benefited.
Nebraska's got it. Best field position, their third possession to their own 47. And the old option, Lord, who ran so well against Texas, has a first down, the first of the day. For Nebraska, close to the 42. Pushed out by Bobby Walker, the safety.
Horn had a great block on Newman. The key to this play, watch the tailback Horn. Watch him work down the football field and make the block on Newman. It's incredible effort, right? Turns inside, seal block. Now there's a cavity, there's a lane for Lord. Excellent seal block, and Lord's off for a first down to move the chains. Great blocking by the tailback.
That's a true freshman at 6 feet even, 190 pounds. First time in K-State territory. Nothing there for Horn on the penetration up front by Andrew Scholl. So a loss of a couple of yards. It'll bring up second and 12. It'll be JB, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy will kick it all off tomorrow. It's the NFL on Fox, and this week, what a combination. Jeff Garcia and Terrell Owens have become in San Francisco. We'll take a look at it. Plus, Terry Bradshaw is going to name the top 10 young quarterbacks later today. Dave Lapp is going to talk about the very best of the Big 12. Fox NFL Sunday tomorrow.
You are the king of the segue. You are the master. I'm bowing to your greatness.
Second and a dozen. It's early. Wide side of the field. Horn can't get out of the backfield. Unbelievable play on the outside once again by Brian Hickman, the young man who was knocked out of the game after one snap. He's back, and in a big way.
One thing that you cannot have if you're running the option is penetration, and Kansas State repeatedly is getting penetration past the line of scrimmage.
Well, Dave, your assessment of the Big 12 quarterbacks.
Well, I broke them down into categories. We got the two best running quarterbacks in this football game today, Lord and Roberson. Throwing the football, Kingsbury and Sims. They're playing tonight down in Lubbock. All-purpose guys that can do both best, Seneca Wallace and Brad Smith. And look at these three guys right there. You got Kingsbury, you got Sims, and you got Seneca. They're all O'Brien candidates.
Lord throwing it up for grabs and throwing it behind Wilson Thomas. Not close as Terrence Newman was over there. Safety converged as well, Bobby Walker.
The Davey O'Brien National Quarterback Award is presented annually to the nation's best college quarterback, and the Big 12 has three of the 14 finalists. Nice.
So the turnover as getting off the field very slowly is Villa Waldrop, the right tackle.
That's a big boy.
Yes. Better than 330, 340. The turnover does not burn Kansas State. It definitely should hurt them in field position, though. Larson to Newman. Newman doesn't want the fair catch. Yes, he put it up very early. Back near the 7-yard line. So Kansas State, longest field of the day. But Wildcats are up by 7.
Look closely, and you can see a CEO, a senator, a teacher. With the largest leadership studies program in the Big 12, it's easy to see why Kansas State University is ranked by high school counselors as one of the top 10 undergraduate experiences in the nation. Start your future as a leader. Kansas State University.
College Football Saturday presented by Kyocera. Welcome back to one of our favorite places in the Big 12. And what a beautiful scene we've got today. Colors have changed in the 50s. We're in Manhattan, Kansas. And what a confrontation between two teams that all of a sudden it's a grudge match. In recent years, Kansas State has improved that much. And Roberson, quarterback draw, takes it across the 8 to the 9 for a gain of 2. Jim Knox.
Joe, I'll tell you what, number 84, Nebraska, John Bowling, the big tight end, really took a shot in the knee that last series. On the bench, they're checking the knee out right now. As you see, he's standing up for the first time in a bit of pain, but he's going to see if he can get back in.
Looks like he's got pretty good range of motion there, Knoxie. He could definitely get Bowling it bowled over on that little naked bootleg, and Lord really had no opportunity and threw the ball low, and Bowling got chopped by a couple of guys, but hopefully the way he's moving looks like he's going to make the dance.
Roberson has yet to throw the football. He's carried it for 48 yards on 9 attempts. Will he put it up? No. He'll follow his lead block of Wilson. Fullback did a good job. There goes Roberson. Now it's a foot race. Will he be able to make it? Quarterback has an angle. I think he'll do it. He's there. Touchdown, Kansas State. How about 91 yards?
Roberson at his best. Quarterback counter. He follows the big fullback Wilson against the block. Look at, he makes Bland miss. Philip Bland, elusive in the open field. Now it's off to the races. Rude can't catch him, the linebacker. Washington can't catch him. Gross finally does, but too late. What an effort by a heck of a running quarterback, L. Roberson. He showed the elusiveness and the explosion in the open field.
Ream for the point after. 14-0 Kansas State. And I don't know about you, Dave. I'm out of breath watching the kid.
I'll tell you, give me the oxygen tank. Mike Johnson, big offensive lineman, did a good job pulling from his guard position and getting out in front again. There's many ways you can run the counter. And they ran the counter with the fullback Wilson and the right guard Johnson pulling. Watch Johnson pull, and Wilson's going to fit in there as well, the big fullback. Johnson pulls around, gets the block. Wilson picks his block up, and there goes L. Now Philip Land is frozen, makes him miss in the open field, has a seam. See you later. Looking over his shoulder like, oh, where are they? Uh-oh, here they come. Got to turn on the Jets. Finally, Gross catches up with him, but too late, he's in the end zone. What an effort. Great execution up front. Great execution fullback Wilson. Outstanding by L, the running quarterback.
Nebraska's given up an average of 121 yards a game on the ground. Already, Roberson on his own, 139 on 10 carries, thanks to the 91-yarder. the longest of the season for Kansas State. Kansas State is hoping for some help. Not only tonight from Iowa State, but don't forget next week on Fox Sports Net against Nebraska at Nebraska. And especially after the way Colorado handled Nebraska in Boulder last year, you never know, they could get it. Josh Davis from the goal line. Slowed down to the 15. Did a good job to get it across the 23 to the 24. Well, we were talking about the way Kansas State has been battling to make up ground in the rivalry with Nebraska. Bill Snyder, though, does like their progress.
Nebraska's been a tremendous program for 30, 35 years, and whatever the number happens to be. We certainly can't lay claim to that, but I'm pleased with the progress that's been made here, quite certainly, and I think our players and past coaches and people that surround our program, you know, have a strong feeling about the tradition, if you will, that is being established.
Lord with a nifty run in the secondary. Don't want to step on the excitable Bill Snyder as it goes across the 44 to the 45.
I'll tell you, Lord says, hey, whatever you can do, Al, I can try to do better. We got the two best running quarterbacks in the conference, and they're showing it today. Jamal Lord has long legs. He's a long strider. But uniquely, he's also got the jackhammer feet that can make you miss in the open field. Look at that. Almost 14 yards of lug right there. Two touchdowns. That is amazing effort.
Well, Dave, don't forget, we saw him with 234 yards on the ground against a very good Longhorn defense.
Yeah, that was a Nebraska quarterback record.
Lord, wide open, Harry in the tight end. He runs like a wide receiver. The true freshman's got a first down inside the 27-yard line. He caught the big touchdown to make it a three-point game late against Texas.
Well, coming into today's game, he had three catches for 137 yards, averaged over 45 yards a catch. Harry, a 235-pounder. Now, what you have is a guy that can run like a receiver. And I'll tell you, he gets off the line of scrimmage very easily. He's in the slot, and he just runs a wide receiver route. Basically, he was a slot receiver in alignment and just ran a very easy route. No play action involved.
It's taken away by the fullback. Lord recovers nicely as Newman pounces on him. They lose yardage back to the 32, but a break, because it was very similar to the fumble by Roberson where he put it to the fullback, tried to pull it back, and then lost it.
Exactly. You got fullback and quarterbacks doing tug-of-war out there. They're going to have to get on the same page. If the quarterback's yanking it out of the belly, don't grab at it. The quarterback's the decision-maker. You let him determine the play.
So the dive series almost got away from Nebraska. And they're not the type of team that can make up big yardage that's lost. We just saw that on their last series after the fumble recovery gave them great field position. Now it's going to be second and 16. Quarterback counter on his own. Nothing doing. No gain on the carry as Terry Pierce, the inside linebacker, made the hit.
It was almost identical to the play that L. Roberson just took for the touchdown. They pulled the right guard, and Judd Davies, the big fullback, ran the counter, and he ended up the lead blocker for Lord. Kansas State defended it much more handily than Nebraska did, obviously, when Roberson goes 91 to the house.
Davies and Horn in the I formation on another second and make it third and 16. Lord slowed down, and he was down. And he was down right out of field goal territory on that sack all the way back to the 37-38 yard line of the final snap. It should be. That will be of a very strong first quarter for Kansas State. That's the end of the first 15 minutes of play. Dominating effort by Kansas State, especially on the ground, with the score of the Wildcats 14, the Huskers nothing. You're watching College Football Saturday, presented by Kyocera on Fox Sports Net.
Love me when I'm gone. Not see under my skin. I won't tell you a damn thing that I could not tell my friends.
Not what Nebraska was looking for on the road. Our Lycos game summary. So we welcome you back to Manhattan for the start of the second quarter. Roberson, he has been the man. He has not had to really put the ball up at all. And it's the longest run by a Wildcat since way back in 1948.
Wow.
Largest margin of victory was 1953 between these two teams, at least for Kansas State, when they won 27-0. And now Larson trying to find a corner. It's down the middle, and a great job as it's put in the end zone. It was first touch down on the goal line. And a sensational back-breaking effort for Nebraska by their defensive back, DeJuan Gross.
Let's take a look at execution of similar plays and different results. L. Roberson, watch the right guard, Johnson, pull, and the fullback. Rude is unblocked. Linebacker Rude is unblocked. They both block the same guy, but he runs away. He separates from Rude, makes the unblocked guy miss. Then he makes Bland miss. I mean, L. Roberson just elusive in the open field. Little different formation, but watch Judd Davies and the right guard Cody pull. Same type of deal. Watch Pierce. He stays at home. Unblocked man makes the tackle. The difference is the linebacker on one made the tackle. Linebacker on the other, he couldn't make the tackle. L. Roberson made him miss.
A net of only 18 yards on the punt. Roberson following his fullback again. What a job of the fullback with a seal and a first down. As the safety came over, Philip Bland almost picking up a late flag. A gain of 14.
Okay, now, in college football, the body can go in the end zone, the ball can't. Gross is in position. It doesn't matter if he's in the goal line. The ball has not advanced the goal line. That's still good. But now, trying to recover the football. Oh, just can't control it. It bounces into the end zone. Made a valiant effort, did Hasselbrink. But boy, if he could have controlled that ball, it's 1 yard line. He couldn't control it. The ball goes in the end zone, touchback.
On first down, Sproles going low. Kind of tough to say he goes high. He's got it across the 37 for about three and a half yards. And what a running effort right now, Dave. 17 carries overall for Kansas State before that snap for 181 yards. Under the 181, 153 belonging to L. Roberson. Now, this is a big blow. Wilson has been integral early in blocking for the quarterback.
They've run a quarterback counter, and the counter has been, instead of pulling the guard and the tackle from the backside, it's been the guard and the fullback fitting. And Wilson has done an excellent job as the second guy leading through, and Bill Snyder hustling out the football field to see the status of his player, not only concerned that he's been playing well today, but concerned for the well-being of his student-athlete. And it doesn't look good. They're checking that lower leg, and Wilson in some obvious pain, and Bill Snyder consoling him. Well, they're checking the ankle, they're checking the Achilles, they're checking everything.
It's obvious a kid that tough has to be in that much pain. He transferred from Michigan State and saw a lot of time as a redshirt freshman the Spartans before coming over to K-State.
When they're checking like that, they're checking for broken bones. I mean, they're looking at range of motion stuff and seeing if he's got a fracture. I mean, that's not good. I don't want to speculate. I'm certainly not a doctor, but I've seen that before, and it's never very good.
So they'll take a look at the junior from Howell, Michigan. We'll cross our fingers for the young man and come right back to Manhattan. Travis Wilson made it off the field with the aid of the staff. It looked pretty good, actually. He did put some weight down on the foot, and the ankle that we were talking about is replaced by Victor Mann. As Mann stays in, they send out Sproles. And now Roberson following Victor Mann, who didn't have a bad block. He stood his man up to the 41-yard line. That's Victor Mann with two ends, the other man with one end.
Let's take a look at Wilson right here. Watch him come through the line of scrimmage. Watch a teammate step on that left foot as he's going through the line of scrimmage. Not sure if the injury occurred there. He kind of locks feet up right here.
Yes.
And then as he works his way down into the play, he gets stood up, he gets high, and DeMario Williams knocks him backwards. Now as he comes down, he's caught in a big pileup, and he's rolled up from behind. He could have been hurt in that spot as well.
It's third and three, and one of the few times they get Roberson and deny the first down try. Jim Knox.
Joe, real quick, Travis Wilson, from my vantage point on the bench, has his left shoe off. They're checking out the ankle right now, as you say. Twisted it underneath the pile. Travis Wilson right now, a great deal of pain.
Yeah, I wonder, it could be foot, could be ankle, could be both. Who knows? But it's a painful injury when you get rolled up like that.
Second of the nation in punt returns. First try for DeJuan Gross. And it's off his hands. Didn't call for the fair catch. Kansas State, I believe, comes
halo
up with it.
Halo
but
violation.
It will be a halo violation.
Yeah.
Flags down to the play.
Going to have a 10-yard, they're going to have the ball and a 10-yard advantage due to the halo penalty, interference with the opportunity to catch the football. Have to stop in that before that 2-yard area.
That's tough. Tough call.
Ran into that, ran in and tried to work his way back out, did the Kansas State cover man. Kind of got in the halo and then worked his way to his left to get out of it. Potential huge turnover there. Let's take a look right here. Watch. Gets in the halo, then works his way out. Take a look. He steps out of it. Boy, that's tough.
You said it. That's what I thought.
He's not even in his line of vision. He's gotten out of his line of vision. Here he comes, and now his man's in the halo. But what about the cover man? What about Newman? Newman's a return guy. One, is that 2 yards? And he's trying to stay out of the way. He's backpedaling. I hate the halo rule. I hate it. Get rid of it and let the guy either fair catch or return the football.
It's a gamble guy by Gross. He got burned. And he is absolutely rewarded for it. Because Newman, he went past Newman. You could see he was trying to stop, and the play was already past him.
Newman was trying to backpedal to make sure he got out of the way. You know, one guy's returning. Newman and Gross, one's returning, one's covering against each other. Great matchup all day.
Nebraska's fifth possession already. Diedrich slamming it for a couple out to the 37. And another flag on the play.
That's usually holding. I don't know. Usually it's offensive holding. No, a face mask on this one. That's going to be of the 5-yard variety, not the 15, I'm sure.
Oh, what a week it was for defensive back Bobby Walker, the senior from Tyler, Texas. As last week against Iowa State in the win, not one, but two interception returns for touchdowns. What a year he has had.
He really has. He's got 5 interceptions now in the season. 177 yards on the year. Interception returns leads the country. He took 2 back for touchdowns last week. He took another one back earlier in the season. 3 interceptions of his 5 have gone for touchdowns. That ties for best in the country. He has been prolific.
So Dr. Pepper, Big 12 Player of the Week, Bobby Walker. It'll be the fullback. Man. Going and spinning for a first down is Judd Davies, a junior from Omaha. All the way across the 45, the last 3 or 4 yards, he went backwards. Terry
Pierce. Bobby Walker, you know, at the safety position, you not only have to intercept the ball, you have to, now he's playing linebacker. He's the extra man in the box, and he kind of was, he didn't want to mess with that box too much. He was kind of just, you know, staying around the edges of it and seeing if something might spring out of there. And
the home run threat is in there. David Horn taking over for Diedrich in the backfield. They go to the boundary to the short side. And Lord will keep it himself. Look out. Knocked out of bounds close to the 30-yard line. First down. Jamal Lord. Touchdown saving bump by Rashad Washington, the strong safety.
Rashad Washington.
Like, whenever you have a long run at Nebraska, you have wide receivers, the best blocking group of wide receivers in the country. Clem, watch Clem right here. Clem comes in, crackback block right there. He's knocked down the defender. Now on the edge goes Lord, and he turns it up the football field. John Clem comes in motion as a wide receiver and takes down a linebacker, and that gets the play started. One less man for Lord to deal with. Great block.
First and 10, the ball at the 31 of Kansas State. And Lord wants to throw. And under throwing Thomas, who adjusts nicely to make that catch. Wilson Thomas, a senior from Omaha, will be right back to Manhattan. First, though, a Dr. Pepper game break with Chris Rose.
All right, Joel, we're all tied up at the big house. Anthony Davis didn't play last week, but he's gained more than 100 so far in the first half, just like L. Roberson for you guys out of K-State.
Nice comeback early, Chris, by Wisconsin after trailing 14-0. So they've got it locked up at halftime.
Boy, Wilson Thomas on that adjustment to the football, Joel. He's 6'6", basketball player, great body control, came back for the ball marvelously.
Jumbo look in the backfield, and Lord chopped down again, Andrew Shaw. He has penetrated since the first snap of the game.
Has he ever.
But back to the catch by Wilson Thomas, because it fluttered, it was low and away, and he came back to get it.
Yeah, and this is a guy, as said, he's a basketball player, so he's got tremendous body control. And he's working against the best cover guy, Newman. Now, he's 6'6", so he basically boxes Newman out. He gets the body position, and he keeps that big body in front of Newman and secures the ball. Nice adjustment to the underthrown football.
Let's see if we see a similar formation from Nebraska. Now they spread it a little bit. Thomas with one wide out.
We got two tight ends in there, though.
And Lord throwing the fade into the corner. Four Thomas overshoots him. Defending on the play, Randy Jordan, the senior, or make it a junior from Tulare, California.
You know, one guy that really struggled in the game that we had, Joel, when they go multiple wides is James Dunnigan. I wouldn't be surprised to see Nebraska go multiple wides and try to get a matchup with Dunnigan. Maybe put Wilson Thomas on James Dunnigan with that big height advantage. Dunnigan had trouble finding the ball at Texas.
Nebraska is going to call a timeout, figure out what they want to do. Third goal situation. We come right back to Manhattan with exactly 11 minutes left in the first half. College Football Saturday on Fox Sports Net. Brought to you by Kia Sera, one company, countless solutions. By the Cabot Collection, imported from Italy, make it interesting. And by Dr. Pepper, your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Nebraska needs it. They need it big time. Shift the momentum of the game. It's third and goal at the 10.
That's Harry and the big tight end. They moved out there as a wideout.
Lord looking on the little turn in. And it's knocked away from Harrington at the goal line.
Yeah, they went. They put Harrington out there. They think he's probably their best receiver.
Bobby Walker read it perfectly.
And he's a big tight end that they put out wide, motioned him away from the tight end position, trying to get a one-on-one matchup. And he ran the inside route in an excellent position. Kansas State is right there to make a play on the football. Well, that's a great job inside by Rashad Washington.
It'll be a 27-yard field goal to try by Josh Brown on its way, and Nebraska's on the board. So Jamal Lord with the big run, and the catch by Wilson Thomas set it up. They couldn't capitalize first and goal, but got the field goal. We'll go back with Senator Chris Rose at our College Football Saturday studio show with a preview of the Nissan Halftime Reports.
Coming up on the Nissan Halftime Report, I'll be joined by Kellen and Artie with all the scores and highlights. Can Iowa run the table in the Big Ten for the first time in school history? And we'll preview our late game, Colorado and Iowa State. But right now, back out to Manhattan with Joel, Dave, and Jim.
All right, Chris, and an 11-point lead as it's kicked right on the pylon into the end zone, taking the return game away. Great job by Josh Brown. And I bring that up because Terrence
There's
Newman.
A flag. They threw a flag, a late flag on that play.
And it's just inside the 20-yard line. Otherwise, it would be at the 20.
Now, their discussion is the pylon inbounds or out of bounds? That's what the discussion is right now.
Well, it went inside. It hit the inside of the pylon. There's no doubt. It was on our side of the field.
And they're calling it different. It's a personal foul on the return, even though it hit the pylon. And you got to get points for hitting that pylon from that distance. I mean, that's a sharpshooter right there to knock that pylon down. That's a heck of a shot. But there's a personal foul and the return as well.
Dead ball, personal foul against the receiving team after the play. We have the distance to go. First down.
Through Kansas State, last three times they've had it. Well, after they fumbled the ball away, the field position didn't help them. But the last three times they've had it at their own 7, the 20, and now back at the 10 in good news, at least for Wildcat fans. Talk about tough. Travis Wilson. We thought they were taking him to the hospital for x-rays.
Yeah, really.
He's back in there in front of Darren Sproles. Sliding in motion on the first down. Sproles. They collared him early, but it didn't make any difference. More they can't deny him. He got just about four. Now, later today on College Football Saturday, presented by Kia Sera, it's a Big 12 North showdown. Seneca Wallace and Iowa State trying to bounce back after getting hammered by the same K-State squad. They're in Boulder taking on Chris Brown, the 17th-ranked Colorado Buffaloes, the top team in the Big 12 North. Bill Land and Gary Reasons with the call later today from Folsom Field in Boulder. Iowa State, Colorado, 7 o'clock Eastern, right here on Fox Sports Net. That is a super matchup later tonight.
Sure is. Chris Brown leading the nation in rushing.
Sproles chopped down after a half a yard. And let's look ahead at what's coming up for you down the stretch. And what a stretch it's going to be in the Big 12 and the Pac-10. Washington, Washington State, that's next Saturday night, 6:30 Eastern. Then on Friday, Thanksgiving weekend, we'll have Arizona State traditional against Arizona, 3 o'clock Eastern. Saturday, Dave, we're going to be in Stillwater. Oklahoma is going to try to pay back the Cowboys for what happened last year in Norman.
All the battles of the states, those are huge. We got three of them coming your way, the state championships.
So now third and 5, ball to the 15. Roberson looking to the slant, wide open. He's got Taco Wallace. And make it James Terry instead. Terry with a big catch, beating the defensive back, Fabian Washington, the true freshman. And he's got it to the 42-yard line. That was too easy on the slant.
Well, what you got is a guy that's 6'5", working against a true freshman that's barely 6 feet tall. And they like this matchup. They got the one-on-one matchup. Fabian Washington beaten badly inside by Terry. He does recover and make the play. But remember the game we had, Texas, Roy Williams really did a job. And there's another guy, 6'5". Roy Williams, 6'4". They want that matchup. Big, tall, upperclassman against, you know, the undersized Fabian Washington at 6 feet, 170 pounds down here.
Roberson is going to work out of the gun. Flanked by Wilson. Fakes it and a run it with a block and a beauty from Wilson again. He's near another first down. I think he's got it. He does. Inside the 33. Can't say enough about the blocking, though, of the transfer from Michigan State, the junior Travis Wilson.
Not only him, the offensive line, there's no penetration at all. I mean, Wilson is getting through the line of scrimmage clean. And when he gets through clean, watch everybody get their blocks up front. Everybody's wired. That's outstanding. Now, he comes through clean one-on-one, gets his block. There's nobody that's even getting off the blocks. I mean, it's almost easy out there. L. Roberson getting into the secondary before he's touched. Tremendous domination up front by the big folks.
196, single-game record. He's close to that in the first half. Sproles sliding, and then Kelsey gets him around the collar. He's so small, not a bad idea, but there is going to be a hold.
Yeah. But Sproles, did he look like a skier? I mean, he planted both his skis and jumped sideways 4 yards.
Was he on a blue or a black run?
I'm telling you, he was on the diamond run. That was a jewel there. I mean, he just absolutely, you talk about a lateral cut. He planted both feet and jumped.
Yeah, fortunately for K-State, the hold comes on a first down.
Yeah, and that gets you off schedule. And the holding is done by the big center, we believe, big Mr. Washington. And he's going to Washington. And watch, right here.
Good
hand
call.
Outside the framework of the body, and now the body slam, you know, and that was right at the point of attack, obviously, as Sproles did that magnificent cut and jump.
Whew. That's a real good call by Hal Dowden, his Big 12 crew. It is first and 20. And what a jump on L. Roberson.
Rude.
As they pull him down, Barrett Rude, the middle linebacker.
Treated him rudely.
Sophomore from Lincoln. Noxie, what's the latest?
Joe, I tell you what, I've been keeping my eyes on Chris Kelly, the fine defensive end. You guys talked about him, missed the last six games with a torn hamstring. Been going strong now for a quarter and a half. This could be the reason why. It's called Roller Cream, a thin material put on his right hamstring. They taped it up really nice, keeps the heat in. He put a right sleeve on it, and he's going 110% out there right now.
I'll tell you, Noxie, that rubber sleeve does keep it warm. You put it over that material, and you get a built-in heat going.
On second and long, Roberson. A ton of time. Kelsey chases him down. Gets the sack from the backside.
Tried to rip that football out. And Kelsey's flying around the field. You talk about fresh legs. Now, he did have an injured hamstring for 6 weeks, but he's been rehabbing it. And this is just a case of not quitting. You know, coming off the block, never say die, and rip that football out of there. Watch Kelsey with the hand placement and trying to separate from blocks. And he's being blocked by tight ends, by offensive tackles, by pulling guards. Here he trails the play from behind. And this is the big play when he ran L. Roberson down from behind with that backside pursuit. Excellent player.
Roberson out of the gun on third and forever. And going into the end zone, jump ball, looking for Taco Wallace. On the deflection, it hits the deck, close to Wallace.
Boy, that Hail Mary was almost answered.
Also back there, Derek Evans, the junior from Denver. They were all in that neighborhood. See, on third and 24.
I think Jamal Lord should throw the Hail Marys. When your last name's Lord, you got to throw the Hail Marys. They get answered then. You know what I'm saying? But now we got Kansas State. We'll be playing field position here and trying to pin Nebraska back once again and give them a long field to negotiate.
So they stalled at the Nebraska 47. And let's see if DeJuan Gross plays a little safer back around his own 10-yard line.
I thought he made a mistake, fair catch in the last one.
Travis Brown with a knuckleball.
Or Newman did.
Gross doesn't call for the fair catch. And they corral him early across the 20, out near the 22. So decent shape for Nebraska considering what it could have been. but he punted it right down the middle. You ready for some hoops? What a good start for the basketball season for a Big 12 team last year, Texas. But it's ACC Sunday Night Hoops. It's back on Fox Sportsnet. Starting December 1st, the Temple Owls taking on Wake Forest. ACC against the Atlantic 10. ACC Sunday Night Hoops. It all tips off December 1st right here on Fox Sportsnet.
Chaney against Prosser.
Can you break down the matchup zone?
I'll tell you, boy, that
is... if I had Tim Duncan back at Wake Forest, I think I could.
Yeah, that matchup zone, that's a junk defense that drives coaches crazy.
Davies and Horn in the I formation. Now they run the wing back.
Oh,
Lord looked at him but couldn't go that way. As Mark LaFleur was in motion behind him, Rashad Washington, though, with a crack on his knee.
Boy, that was a solid hit because Lord, 220 pounds, has got deceptive power. But Washington put his helmet across the bow, across Lord's body, and took him down. Tremendous tackle.
Now, these two teams, when they get in third and long, we've talked about how good they are at running the football. Third best for Nebraska and fifth best for Kansas State. When they got to throw the football, they really have problems.
Yep,
that's out of 117 teams in Division 1A play, don't forget.
That's not their forte.
Now on second and 10, the quarterback keeper.
Wow, look at that.
Loss of three.
Look at that.
Great pursuit.
Man, they had bodies everywhere.
And coming out of the secondary, actually, is Josh Buell, the outside backer. He runs like a defensive back at 6 feet, even 210 pounds. It's College Football Saturday presented by Kyocera. As you in Wagner Field, Manhattan, Kansas, the Little Apple. We've got a little more than 5 minutes to play in the first half. One dominated by Kansas State so far, leading by 11. Could be worse, though, for Nebraska.
Great gang tackling by Kansas State on that last play.
Now on second and long, the middle screen. Almost intercepted.
Man.
Pulled down. Melvin Williams had it in his paws, the senior from Melville High School in St. Louis, and he's in the end zone.
Melvin Williams is basically can't believe that he didn't come up that play. 6'3", 270-pound senior on senior day saw a golden goalpost. I mean, the ball's in the air. Melvin says it's mine. Oh, son of a gun, it's not. Didn't have those soft enough hands, but great job of getting airborne at the appropriate time. And it kind of went through his hands, hit him in the face mask, and fell to the turf harmlessly.
Back deep, it's going to be Derek Evans, the reserve wide receiver, waiting for Kyle Larson. Punt, it's blocked! Another block punt! Scooped up inside the five into the end zone as Elsa got the block, and K-State says they have it, and they do. Touchdown, Wildcats!
I thought Marcus Patton might have gotten in there and involved a little bit, too. They brought Terrence Newman off his widest, off the kill man for Nebraska and brought him.
Johnson got the score. The linebacker, Jared Johnson, with the recovery in the end zone, Dave.
Boy, just an incredible effort now. That's the seventh kick on the season blocked by Kansas State. That's the fifth punt. They blocked a field goal and they blocked an extra point. Excellent play by Kansas State to heat it up at the appropriate time. Get a big touchdown by special teams. Huge play, huge mistake by Nebraska.
Ream for the point after. And the special teams do come through. So we've been talking about the punt returners so often. But it was the block of the score. 21-3 Wildcats. Josh Davis waits for the kick as Kansas State has broken it wide open. They are looking for their third consecutive win at home in the series with Nebraska. A one-sided affair overall, but not recently. Kansas State needs it to have a shot at the Big 12 North title. And the line drive from Bright is going to be brought out by Davis from 2 yards into his own end zone with a nice lane over to the right side. Good return across the 30, out to the 31-yard line, but a huge play before we went away.
Oh, watch Newman. Watch him sneak in here and watch coming off the edge. This is where the punt is blocked, but Newman confuses him a little bit. As Newman works his way in, both of those guys coming off the edge, and the block is made right there by Marcus Patton. And Marcus Patton takes it right off the punter's foot. It goes airborne and just takes it right off his foot. Marcus Patton does a great job of a nice aiming point to block it.
Lord calling his own number again. Got a good point guard, shares the basketball, but right now Jamal Lord utilizing his own skills for the most part. He's 3-for-9 passing. He's now 9-for-35 rushing. And Wilson to the locker room.
Yeah, going in early to, you know, I'm sure he's probably getting retaped. You know, he tried to play. He might be suffering some swelling. Maybe they're going to retape it. Sometimes you can tape that ankle so tight it's like a cast.
All of a sudden you see it turning purple down there.
Yeah, and you don't cut it off forever because as soon as you cut the tape off, boom, it swells up like a balloon.
And a 2 by Lord brings up 2nd and 8. 3-of-9, would it be 4-of? No, almost intercepted. Jumping in front, the defensive back, Rashad Washington, in front of Matt Herrien. So it's going to bring up 3rd and long. Now 3-of-10 passing, Dr. Pepper trivia. K-State has been to 9 consecutive bowl games. How many did they go to before this streak, the current streak with Bill Snyder?
Wow.
That is tied for the most. There's 7 other teams. They're 1 of 7 in the nation to go to 9 consecutive bowl games. David Horn stays in the backfield on 3rd and 8. How big a play is this? Field position especially. Lord in trouble. And throws it into the ground. Wilson Thomas the closest to it, taking a shot at Rashad Washington in the process, but it almost looked like Lord became flustered and gave up initially after he was bounced around.
Well, he wants to get the ball down the football field. Usually you'd think that Jamal Lord might tuck it and run a little bit in that situation, but it's a long distance, and Pierce, who runs a 4.6 40 and bench presses 520 pounds, likes to knock people around. That was a good shot there down the football field. Nowhere for Lord to go with the ball. Nobody came back to make themselves available to him as a target.
Terrence Newman, will he get a shot to return one? Kyle Larson gets into it.
Wow.
And his best of the day by far. Fair catch called for. Over his head, it drops around the 10. And a roll back to the 12. So that's where Kansas State has it, deep in their own territory. It hasn't bothered them for the most part today, though, with a 21-3 lead. 3:48 left in the half. And this is a nightmare for a team that cannot throw the football, trailing by this many.
No doubt about it. And you look at Kansas State's performance today. Offensive brilliance by L. Roberson and company. Defensive dominance. I mean, they've just flown around the football field, got Nebraska in a lot of 3rd and longs. And the kicking game special teams, Kansas State's favor as well, highlighted by the block punt touchdown. They have dominated every phase of this game. That's why they're up 18 with less than 4 minutes to play in the half.
This is a school record 8th home game this season for K-State. They're 6-1 so far. We're here for the only loss, the 3-pointer to Texas. As L. Roberson is finally collared early on a play. Barrett Rue, the middle linebacker, getting a piece of him. Maybe a half a yard at the most.
Boy, L. Roberson has shown himself to be just a fantastic open field runner. I mean, there are so many. It started with Michael Bishop here at this very school. You know, everybody having the quarterback run package, quarterback counter, quarterback sweep, quarterback draw. Now other schools in the Big 12 and the country are utilizing it, and they still do it here well at Kansas State.
What are the odds on Roberson running it, spreading the defense with 2 to each side? Quarterback draw. Thought he tried. Didn't work, though. Great play. Out on the outside with a flag down to the play. The stop made defensively by Des Moines Adams, the senior from Pine Bluff, Arkansas.
It looked like by the reaction out in the football field, Taco Wallace is going to get called for offensive pass interference. He's very frustrated going to the sideline. He was working down the field against Fabian Washington, and it looks like they may be calling him.
And it didn't look like Roberson ever had any intentions of throwing the football.
And they're calling the personal foul. I wonder if Taco Wallace got up in Fabian Washington's face a little bit, blocking him down the field. He's not happy, though, as he left the field.
So they'll mark it off with 3:01 left in the half.
Personal foul, was it dead ball? I mean, if it's dead ball, they gotta,
if
they
it's
gotta mark
dead
it
ball,
off.
Right, then it's automatic it half the distance.
Right.
If it's not dead ball, they'll decline
personal
it.
Personal foul on the offense. Penalty is declined. 3rd down.
Happened during the course of the
without
action.
A doubt.
Down the field.
That are FedEx Aaron Ground numbers. Big difference.
Yeah, Nebraska's balanced, but, you know, nowhere near enough yards. Look at Kansas State has already rushed for 200. Incredible.
So So deep in their own territory, K-State doesn't need to gamble. Inside of three to play.
Uh-oh.
And the left tackle comes up and early out of his stance.
It's Barnett.
Thomas Barnett, the senior from Oklahoma City.
A sixth-year player. Got a medical red shirt. He's been around as long as Bill Snyder, it seems like.
Missed all of last season. Yeah. As you mentioned, third year as a starter. And a little early.
Yeah, a good count early. And you know what? As a lineman, when you're unsure, you got to come off the football. Get your money's worth. Get the hit in if you're going to blow the play. And don't come off, kind of walking on ice and not hitting anybody.
Now ball security, real important to say the least, this deep in their own territory. And they'll play it safe with Victor Mann breaking tackles, but finally pulled down. That was a lasso.
Yeah.
It looked like the defensive back, Philip Bland, couldn't get him and finally just lifted his leg up and said, take this.
He did. As troops came, Kabongo came over and helped. And then Bland said, picking you up, taking you down.
He was number five.
Talk about this series, though. It's been dominated by Nebraska. This is the 87th meeting. Nebraska's got a 72-12, two ties lead. But they have split the last four games. Now it's kind of a chip on the shoulder situation for K-State.
Does Nebraska try to block this one?
Gross waits. If ever you were going to go for one, you need it now. Travis Brown, lost 3 yards from the back line of the end zone.
Timeout. Personal protector Terry Pierce called timeout, said let's go and talk about it, make sure we get it blocked properly, and we don't want to make a mistake backed up like this.
That's the first timeout used by Kansas State. And we were just talking about the 9 consecutive bowl games for Kansas State. Well, how many did they make it to before the streak?
I bet it's less than the 9. One. It's quite
bowl.
A few less than
well,
9.
Well, let's figure this. 14 years for Bill Snyder in Manhattan to take it a step further. And with his 113 wins, how many years did it take them to pick up that many wins before Snyder came? How about 47 seasons? Well, yesterday we caught up and talked to Bill Snyder about the situation with the polls and especially the BCS system.
In all honesty, there is nothing that we can do other than win. You know, you talk about the BCS and people, allude to that. There's a simple solution to it. You know, whether you like the BCS or you don't like the BCS, the solution is just win. If you win, it will take care of itself.
That's easy enough.
Yeah, just like Al Davis said, just win, baby. And, Bill Snyder, you have to tip your cap to him. Getting a program turnaround is one thing, but sustaining it for almost 15 years is quite another. There's no seat at the top of the ladder of success. You have to work hard to sustain it, and they have. It's been great.
Now can they protect and also keep it away from DeJuan Gross, who's second of the nation. And down the middle it goes. Returnable type for Gross. He's got a lot of real estate in front of him. Newman slowed him down and took him down.
What a play.
Beat two men. Terrence Newman.
What a play.
Incredible.
Man, that is huge. He probably saved his team 30 yards in field position by making that effort.
You're right, because there was a ton of room in front of him.
You know, if these guys, when one's returning, the other one's covering all day long. And Newman split the two guys trying to curtail his effort down the field, and he took Gross to the turf. That is just one fine football play. And what a matchup between those two great players all day long.
So the last thing Gross wanted to say was, hello, Newman.
Yeah, exactly.
First and 10 from the 48, Josh Davis. First appearance in the backfield. We've seen him as a kick return man regularly, but now in the backfield. And Jamal Lord going to his wideout. Quick hitter over to the far side. It's taken in.
Pass was complete to number 89.
Hassebrecht took it in. Short gain. As we look at the way it stands, at least going in this week.
Yeah. You know what bothers me about this? How do you get 3.41? How do you get a 4.8 and 9.3? I like the round numbers, but...
Deep right on the curve?
Forget the computers. Let's do matchups. Have a playoff.
Dead ball foul coming up. Is it a false start against Nebraska? You'd have to think.
How do you get an 11.43?
False start on the offense. 5 yards penalty. Still second down.
I'm always for those pass and field courses myself. What about you?
The thing that bothers me about the BCS, matchups. Sometimes matchups aren't the same, Joel. One team throws the ball well against a team that can't defend it. That's a tougher matchup. If the team can't throw it and they can't run the football, it's different matchups, personnel, every single week.
So now second and long after the mic off. Lord putting it up to grabs. And it truly was anybody's as he went again for Hassebrecht.
Kansas State has done something that very few people have done. Make Nebraska throw the football every snap.
Defense has been the difference for the Wildcats, though.
And they've been all over the football field, laying the level. Look at the gang tackling. No one's on an island. You know, that's a great one-on-one tackle right there. But there's always more than one Wildcat. Literally, there's four or five guys around a lot of times. Jamal Lord has not been able to break a big one. Excellent defense.
Lord. He is 4 of 13 in the passing department, and there's the fifth completion and a huge one to Wilson Thomas. For a first down if it stands. Yeah. There is a flag a couple of yards beyond the line of scrimmage, and Lord took a shot at the end of the play.
Let's see if Kansas State lined up offsides, or did Nebraska have enough guys on the line of scrimmage just being talked about now, offsides, Kansas State.
Yes.
Take the play.
Offsides on the defense. Penalty is declined. Results will play. First down.
Nebraska had to have it going to the locker room.
And here's Wilson Thomas once again. All 6 foot 6 inches of him getting up. You know, he's a basketball player, like I said before. Averaged almost 4.5 points a game, almost 4 rebounds a game last year. And he went up and got that board right there.
Only one timeout remaining for Nebraska. Lord looking in the slant. It's a low throw and a nice catch, did he? Did he come up with it or not? Mark LaFleur, the true freshman. They've used five true freshmen extensively this year. That's how different a year it has been for Nebraska.
Absolutely, and a lot of them made contributions in the passing game, particularly the guy Ross Pilkington set a freshman record with 13 catches this season.
Davis, the other one in the backfield, trips over to the wide side of the field for Lord. On second and about a yard, he can run for the first down. Last helmet doesn't make any difference.
Wow.
Getting to him, Henry Bryant, who lost it, the senior from Boca Raton, Florida.
Boy, he lost his head, but but still made the play. That's just tremendous finish right there. It's desire. Take a look at what, here's Bryant working. The big tackle, incognito, takes, rips his helmet off. That should be a penalty. You can't put the hands to the face mask like that. Incognito got away with one. Great, that's Incognito right there, going to the sideline. That's a great name for an offensive lineman, Incognito. I mean, offensive linemen are always incognito, but Incognito wasn't incognito on that one.
You know what, at the buffet last night, you were far from incognito.
He showed himself up big time. That's a great name for a lineman, Incognito.
Coming up
in
at the
house.
Chris, Kellen, and Artie. The guys in the studio with the Nissan Halftime Report. Top 25 rundown. And also, a preview of tonight's game on Fox Sports Net, a very big one for the Buffaloes, because right now, K-State cruising like they will be on top before it's all over. Plenty of time, though, and Nebraska needs the possession they've got going right now. They've got to get points before they go to the locker room. But Iowa State, Colorado, that is later tonight on Fox Sports Net. That's 7 o'clock Eastern.
Well, Kansas State, the last two Big 12 games, Kansas and Iowa State, they've outscored the opposition 122-7 coming into this football game and doing it again today.
From the 34, third and long. Taylor needs to avoid a loss. Makes something out of nothing, but still shy of the first down now with only one timeout on the board. Tank Reese makes the stop. Another senior on Senior's Day coming up with a big play.
And
a field goal try.
Yep.
It'll be a 37-yard attempt for Josh Brown, who's got one today. He is 10 of 13 on the season. He's accounted for their only points, and a timeout is going to be called by Kansas State. And it was good.
Yeah, he got it away nicely.
He did. Nice 47, 48-yard practice.
Yeah.
So from the practice range, he goes to the first tee. Now, will it be the same? Brown had a good year last year. His senior season, a real solid year. He has been 6 of 8 this year from this distance, Dave, between the 40 and 49.
Well, there's old Tank Reese that made that play, and he's a customized tank. I mean, he's got usually tanks have no gears, no shifting. You know, they can't go more than just one speed. This tank's got a gearbox, and he's got cushioned seats, and he's a customized tank. He's 5'10", 280 pounds, great change of direction. Keeps his pad level low at 5'10". You have to come off the line of scrimmage on your knees to get underneath his pads.
Well, none of us are ever going to forget the matchup between these two teams in 1998. Michael Bishop, the quarterback, he threw for 306 yards. Darnell McDonald with some nice moves on that play. He had a couple of touchdowns on the day. Bishop, how about running it for 140 besides throwing for 306? And again, finding McDonald late. And Kansas State snapped the streak, a 29-game winning streak. Bring them down.
Yep.
40-30, a 10-point victory. And they won again 2 years ago on this surface. Now, the 48-yard try. Plenty of distance.
Oh, yeah, he's good.
He's done it again. Josh Brown, 2-for-2 on the day, and now 11-for-14 on the season. He's their only offense. So a game of catch-up continues for Nebraska, but a pick-me-up before they go to the locker room.
Now there's three phases, snap, hold, and kick. All executed well, decent protection, nice elevation. He got that ball up quickly, and he split it. I mean, he is right down the heart of those uprights.
Well, that's good for about 55 easy, isn't it?
Yeah. And, you know, the interesting thing, Nebraska's got field turf. So does Kansas State now. They installed field turf at this stadium. And so the surface is very familiar to Brown. He kicks on it every week at home.
6 seconds left. You've got to believe they're going to squib it. Keep it on the ground. Don't let Newman, who's got a 34.5-yard average on kick returns, bring it back.
I like your hello, Newman. you don't want him to be saying actually goodbye as you're looking at the back of his jersey. He fields this kick cleanly.
Well,
you're right. You got to.
We couldn't
it.
Believe with 90 seconds to go that Texas in that game punted the ball to DeJuan Gross.
Yeah, I think that they were trying a directional and the guy mishit it. He couldn't have been kicking right down the chute to him like that.
Oh, a little pooch.
A little mortar kick.
Well, you can call for the fair catch. I don't like this either. And it's taken in. It looked like Pierce. It's Pierce who took it in, a former high school running back.
Yeah, he had good hands on that, didn't he?
And you know what? I'll tell you something. That takes nothing off the clock. If you make them touch it and it's on the ground and it's squibbed around, now they can throw the tip drill.
Right, right. And we've seen things like this. Remember LSU, Kentucky, 75-yard Hail Mary.
After a Gatorade.
Unbelievable.
After a Gatorade shower.
So you've seen this type of thing before, and L. Roberson has got... He's got a strong enough arm to get it down the football field, but you're going to have to do something with it after the catch. Maybe the old hook and ladder or something like that.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to take a knee and head to the locker room, and that'll be the case. Can't blame Bill Snyder because things have gone so well.
Oh, yeah.
You don't want disaster as well at the end of the half.
Dominant, dominant first half for his football team.
Down to Jim Knox. Knoxie.
Okay, Coach, I know you didn't like giving up those two field goals, but you got to be pleased your team dominated, especially on defense, holding Nebraska to less than 50 yards on the ground.
Well, we aren't playing well on defense, but, you know, there's 30 minutes of football. You remember how Nebraska came back against Texas A&M, so we just have to keep doing what we do well and maybe play a little bit better, maybe get a little bit more going on offense, hold our own in the special teams.
All right, thank you, Coach. I am running out of real estate right now. Let's head to our college football studios and join Chris, Artie, and Kellen. Chris?
All right, Jim, we don't have a whole lot of real estate up here either, but in the meantime, welcome to the Nissan Halftime Report. I'm Chris Rose, working alongside the Hall of Famer, Kellen Winslow, the coach, Artie Gigantino, and guys, Oklahoma, they've just kicked off. They're trying to rebound after that loss to Texas A&M last week. Baylor, however, obviously the perfect tonic. They have been outscored in their last five games, 222-21. We'll keep you posted in this one. Iowa trying to go unbeaten for the first time in conference play, taking on Minnesota in this one. All Brad Banks, he's being selfish, just keeping it in himself. Scored one on the ground, has tossed three through the air. This is the most complete quarterback going right now.
Indeed it is. When you want to get it done, just put it in your own hands and get it done. Good protection by offensive line, good throw by Brad Banks.
The Hawkeyes trying to win 11 games in a season for the first time in school history. Check in on Wisconsin and Michigan. The Badgers were down 14-0, but Jim Leonard, run, Forrest, run! I was just the running. And then speaking of running, Coach.
Well, there's a football team that's been injured all year. Right now, Barry Alvarez has got his 10th year where he's had a 1,000-yard rusher. 10 in a row, great accomplishment.
The last two, courtesy of that guy, Anthony Davis. Now, Wisconsin, remember, they started 5-0. They're 6-5, and they've gotten beaten up in this series. They've lost 28 of their last 31 to the Wolverines, but hanging tough. But back to what, in my opinion, is the best one-loss team in the entire country, Iowa, because they're so balanced, Kellen.
They are balanced offensively, playing well on both sides, running the ball and throwing the football. And Brad Banks is the key to doing that. He's got a great presence in the pocket, Artie, and he's gotten better each game during the year.
And he's got great statistics in the pocket because so far this year now, he has thrown 26 touchdown passes, only 4 interceptions. Sensational job. That's the only word for this guy. Sensational.
Here's the scenario. If they beat Minnesota today and Ohio State loses either today against Illinois or next week against Michigan, yeah. Iowa heads to Pasadena. Hey, still ahead. If Colorado stops Seneca Wallace today, They punched their ticket to the Big 12 title game. We'll preview that when the Nissan Halftime Report continues.
Did you know the University of Nebraska is a leader in the landscape of computer science and business education? Our J.D. Edwards Honors Program combines business strategy with next-generation computer software. That's how you teach leaders for the 21st century. I'd call that thinking outside the box. There is no place like Nebraska.
Welcome back to the Nissan Halftime Report. Kansas State allowing a nation-low 11 points per game. They've given up just six so far to the Nebraska Cornhuskers. It's 21-6 in Manhattan. Later today, some of you will see Iowa State battle Colorado at 7 p.m. Eastern right here on Fox Sports Net. Another road trip for the Cyclones, which have turned into roadkill as of late. They've dropped three straight away games against Oklahoma, Texas, and Kansas State by a combined score of 128-20. And today, guys, all they get is a Colorado team which can clinch the Big 12 North in front of the home folks, and that means a healthy dose of Chris Brown.
Well, when you think of the Colorado offense this year, you think of one person, and that's tailback Chris Brown. This guy right now is leading the nation in rushing offense. As we take a look at his numbers on the jumbo, he has already rushed for 17 touchdowns this year. He has 1,617 yards. He has become a Heisman Trophy candidate by what he's done, Kellen, running the football.
And if he averages 191 yards his last two ball games, that will put him over the magical number of 2,000 yards for the season. Heisman Trophy voters love Chris, 2,000-yard rushers, and he will be a legitimate contender for the Heisman Trophy.
Yeah, there have been eight of them in the history of Division I football. Five have won that coveted prize. Now, Kansas State will be watching that Colorado-Iowa State game because if the Wildcats hold off Nebraska here in the second half, they're still alive in the Big 12 North. Remember, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, right here on Fox Sports Net. L. Roberson, 91 yards on this play, longest in school history since 1948 when Artie was a defensive coordinator. We got more scores and highlights when the Nissan Halftime Report continues. Welcome back to the Nissan Halftime Report. Nebraska 0-7 against ranked teams on the road under Frank Solich. They have a whole lot of work to do to get that first win. Well, here's the results of our FoxSports.com poll. Should college football fans be arrested for storming the field? More of you say no than yes. Thanks for logging on to FoxSports.com. Critical matchups ahead the next 2 weeks right here on Fox Sports Net. Next Saturday, Washington State could clinch a berth in the Rose Bowl with a victory in the Apple Cup. Then a special Friday edition that's the day after Thanksgiving, Arizona against Arizona State. Then 2 weeks from today, Oklahoma State could destroy any hopes of Oklahoma has of winning it all. Check that out two Saturdays from now. Still ahead, from 9-0 to 9-2. Will the third time be the charm for NC State to win a school record 10th game in a single season? Find out when the Nissan Halftime Report continues. Welcome back to the Nissan Halftime Report. We are through 30 minutes in Manhattan, Kansas. They're dancing for joy so far. They should be. They're up 21-6 over Nebraska. Elsewhere in the Big 12, Quentin Griffin has gotten the fourth-ranked Sooners on the board. He's posted five straight 100-yard rushing games. To the ACC, NC State, and UVA, Matt Schaub to Ottawa Anderson. See, if he was Canadian, it'd be Ottawa Anderson. 21 yards for the touch. Then in the third, we've got Schaub again to Patrick Estes. 6 yards and the touch. UVA 14-3 at that point. But Phillip Rivers has added a touchdown on the ground to get the Wolfpack back in this one. They're looking to avoid their third straight loss for the first time since the 97 season. All right, guys, back to our game, Kansas State and Nebraska. You mentioned it in the kickoff show. Nebraska, please stop the run. They haven't done that so far.
Kansas State's third in the nation rushing the football, but only 43rd in total offense, Hardy, which means they're not very good in throwing the football. But Nebraska, the criticism is they can't make adjustments in the second half. They need to make one this half.
And congratulations, because you did call it. But let me give you an unbelievable stat here. Now, Kansas State has scored 11 non-offensive touchdowns this year with that punt block for a touchdown, number one in the country. They can score anywhere on the field,
you
anytime.
You are incredible.
I know,
the numbers that you come up
unbelievable.
With. Unbelievable.
Spoken like a guy who's a former defensive coordinator and special teams coach in the NFL. And, well, here it is, Artie. What'd you do, edit this play? We'll take you back out to the second half for Nebraska and Kansas State. You've been watching the Nissan Halftime Report.
No flags behind it. It's touchdown.
Gives it to Nancy
in the middle. She swings. She got it down. Regional champions.
Oklahoma.
The Texas Longhorns are national champions.
And the winner is Eric Crouch of Nebraska.
The first man in the history of athletic competition to go undefeated. Never a loss.
It's a classic football Saturday in the Midwest, and what a matchup between Nebraska and Kansas State, so far dominated by K-State's Wildcats. Joel Myers along with Dave Lappin, 2-1 offensively in total net yards, and most of the yards for K-State from their quarterback, L. Roberson.
And most of those on the ground, 160 yards rushing. He had two touchdowns, including the 91-yard scamper. Here it's a pass, breaks down. Great coverage down the field. L. Roberson says, I'm just going to take it and run. Makes people miss, runs through tacklers. Amazing effort. This one was incredible. Little counterplay. His fullback Wilson makes a good block. His pulling lineman. He makes Bland miss in the open field, and now he just sprints away. And then once again, little quarterback counter with the fullback Wilson leading the way. L. Roberson has been impossible to stop. Let's take it down to the sideline where Jim Knox had a chance to catch up with Frank Solich. Knoxy?
All right, Dave, just got through talking to Frank Solich. He said they can't give up any more big plays. They got to find pressure on L. Roberson. Also, offensively, they have to finish drives. He did tell me, keep in mind, they are capable of coming back. They did it against Texas A&M at College Station, guys. They came from 17 down.
A different defense, though, Knoxy. In fact, the fourth best in the nation in total defense. And Kansas State, the only team in college football that has finished in the top five in total defense in each of the last five seasons under Bill Snyder. So you're right, they can come back, but not a similar defense like they saw against Texas A&M. Victor Mann is going to get the start at fullback due to the injury to Travis Wilson. Also in the backfield, Darren Sproles, but this time Sproles on the sideline. As Roberson's going to work out of the shotgun. And now an early timeout. So Kansas State will use their first in the first 5 seconds of the second half. Roberson.
Well, where has he run the football successfully? Oh, how about to the left? I mean, that's where he started his 91-yard touchdown, and then he cut it back to the middle. So it started left, but just a tremendous effort. Roberson averaging almost 9 yards a crack on 18 carries. He's run the ball up the middle more than anything on those quarterback draws, and Nebraska's done a good job of rallying to him. But well, when you have a 91-yard touchdown run, it makes your numbers look dramatic, and they are.
Yeah, he averages 74.5 yards a game. He's already doubled that. Plus, he's got 160, as Dave mentioned, on 18 carries. Didn't need to throw the ball. Only one completion. He was one of two. That was to Terry for 42 yards on the quick slant to beat Washington, the true freshman. And don't forget later tonight, right after Iowa State, Colorado, the NFL show on Fox Sports Net, all presented by the U.S. Postal Service. Guys are going to head back to the Goose's neck of the woods, and that's Baltimore. It's Tommy Davidson and Tony Saragusa. Could do some damage. Check it all out. The NFL show later tonight on Fox Sports Net. First snap of the second half, as Iowa State won the toss to start the game, deferred to the second half, leading by 15 on an offside call, but is the left side lifting up early, and did the tight end come up early on that side?
Yeah, it looked like Johnson.
The snap, ball starts on the offense, 5 yard penalty, still first down.
Johnson came out of his 3-point stance, the defensive end from the rest, but didn't get in the neutral zone, and Kansas State broke that 3-point stance. Here's the difference in the football game right there. I mean, you know, when you outrush Nebraska by almost 160 yards, it's incredible. They've made Nebraska have to throw the football, not because they want to, because they have to. And as you mentioned, Joel, almost a 2-1 advantage. Neither team doing much on third down.
And don't forget, Nebraska's third in the nation in rushing, 289 yards a game. That is best in the Big 12. On the slant, tough grab, and he comes up with it. Making the catch again. It is Evans this time. It's the same pattern, though, that they ran with James Terry. They went for 42 yards, and the junior from Denver gets some big yardage. He gets about 9 on it.
And he was matched up against the best, Dwan Gross, the best that Nebraska has to offer in terms of coverage. And he gets right back on schedule, second and medium.
That was a bullet, though, from L. Roberson. A gain of 11 instead. Makes it second and four.
Roberson on the draw, his own move. And what a move. Past the 35 to the 38. He's got another first down. They just can't find an answer.
No, they can't. And he continues when he runs the quarterback sneaks, when he runs the quarterback draws and counters, it's always by the left guard. Lecky. Watch Lecky. Watch Lecky operate here. Does a good job. So that's finishing a block. That's sustaining. And by the time Kabanga can come off the block, Roberson's down the football field. Nice finish by Lecky.
Lecky, third team all Big 12er last year, a junior. Grapevine, Texas. And a change at the line by Al Roberson, with Darren Sproles the single behind him. There's movement again on that left side of the offensive line because of the indecision offensively from the quarterback.
And Kabanga was in the neutral zone as well. But there's movement on both sides of the line of scrimmage being sorted out by it's a consortium of officials right now. They got a zebra convention going on.
You can't miss Kabongo.
No, once he gets in that neutral zone, that's
fire
big.
The snap. Offside on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
That is a break. It'll be first and five.
And there he is. 6'6", 315. He can't hide. You can run, but you can't hide. And Kabongo can't hide right there.
I do wish they changed that call, though, in college football and let them go with the play so it's a free down for the offense.
Right.
Going to the second mark off against Nebraska. Plenty of mistakes in that direction for Kansas State. They had seven penalties in the first half. The fullback will get it, Victor Mann. He is a redshirt freshman from Fort Worth. At about 3 yards, making it second and a deuce with another flag on the play.
Yeah, the linesman threw the flag. Was Nebraska lined up off sides, or did Kansas State not have six on the line of scrimmage? And they didn't. I think they only had, didn't have seven on the line of scrimmage. I think they only had six. So it's an illegal formation.
Illegal formation on the offense, only six on the line, 5-yard penalty, repeat first down.
Well, Dave, we heard Jim Knox's conversation at the end of the half with Bill Snyder, and he wasn't real pleased, even though he was up 21-6, and he said, we have to cut down on the mistakes.
Yeah, but boy, his team was operating at a fever pitch. I thought they flew around the football field as well as we've seen this year.
2 minutes gone by in the third quarter. And it batted down at the line. Kelsey read it perfectly.
Yep.
Just read the quarterback's eyes.
Kelsey went airborne and swatted it down with the big mucker. You know, and it talked about his quick hands and quick feet. Just like in any endeavor athletically, it starts with your feet and finishes with your hands. And he has great hand placement, and he gets them in their chest of the offensive lineman quickly. And he has the footwork to separate. He's a very, very talented player.
So as opposed to what we saw to start the game by Kansas State, when they were real efficient, at least on the offensive side, now they are sputtering. It's second and long. Roberson with a pump fake, and it's knocked away from behind. Loose ball, Nebraska gets it. Near the 35-yard line. It looked like Shanley got it.
He stripped it. Shanley tomahawk chopped it from behind.
And did Trevor Johnson? Yes, Trevor Johnson on the recovery.
Watch Shanley coming at the top of the screen. You'll see him coming around the edge from the backside. Here he comes. Tomahawk chop. Ball out. And Trevor Johnson recovers it. Big play, big takeaway, short field. Nebraska came out in a different alignment defensively with their front seven, and it confused Al Roberson and Kansas State. They never got in sync in that drive. They had two takeaways today. The only time they were negative in the last 28 years was in 1984, one season.
On first down, short side of the field, Jamal Lord. And he looked like he was down. They say his knee never touched. He's got a chance to take it the distance. Inside the 10, touchdown.
Wow. Tremendous block down the football field that allowed him to get into the end zone by Hasselbruck. Great effort.
What balance, though, as he put the other hand down to make sure his knee didn't go down, or did it go down? Obviously, we'll have another look eventually.
Yeah,
first the point after.
He put the left hand down and formed the tripod. He did a nice job of balancing himself up, and he puts that left hand down and no knee down. That's a great effort. He just pushed himself righted himself, and away he went.
Brown for the point after. And we've got a new game with points off a turnover by Nebraska, and it took them only one snap. So Shanley spiked it away and ripped it away. Trevor Johnson made the fumble recovery. And all of a sudden, an 8-point deficit for the Huskers. College Football Saturday on Fox Sports Net, brought to you by Kyocera. One company, countless solutions. By Acura. Experience the performance today, your local Acura dealer. And by Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Now Kansas State's going to get it back, and they'll get it back right through the end zone through the hands of Terrence Newman. They'll have it at their own 20. A little more than 2 minutes gone by, and Lord did a great job to maintain his balance.
He sure did. Look at him put that left hand down a couple of times to right himself and get upright. Now he's in the open field, and this is where he can make you miss. He's creative in that open field. He gets a downfield block, and away he goes for the score. Final guy, whoop, miss. Cut back inside, score. Watch the block right here. Boom. Take Newman down. That's a tremendous block by the wide receiver, and he got his head across Newman, Hasselbrook, and then Lord finishes. Great blocking by the wide receivers, as usual, by Nebraska.
Spread the defense. Roberson on the counter. Belted in the backfield again and driven down.
Trevor
Johnson all over the play. The man who just came up with a fumble recovery, the junior from Lincoln. So all of a sudden, and you mentioned it right before we went away, Craig Bohl, the defensive coordinator, has come out with a different look. He's made adjustments at halftime.
He has. He's got his linebackers lined up a little differently. It's like a 4-4 front, an 8-man front with a 4-4 configuration. And L. Roberson was, you know, they called a timeout early in the series. He was late trying to check in that audible system, confusing them a little bit, taking them out of their game.
Sproles in the eye with Victor Mann on the pitch. Johnson turns him in, back into the congestion. Doesn't make any difference. He lost the football to the end of the
Ball's
play,
out.
Though.
Ball's
running
out.
Into his own man. Who's got it? Nebraska says they've got it,
wow.
And they do. Do you believe it?
Third takeaway of the day for the Cornhuskers. They were -3 coming in. They're even now. They're +3 today. Kansas State +14 coming in. Now -11, -3 on the day.
Josh Bullock's a free safety, came out of the pile with the football, but it was turned inside to the congestion by Trevor Johnson.
Yeah, I thought he got a face mask, but I guess he didn't. And the ball, and people just hustling, gang tackling, flying across. The guy that made the hit on the play looked like
Bingham.
The nose guard, Bingham,
yes.
Hustling down the field, and he stripped the ball out of there. Good hustle.
So now from the K-State 24, Lord looking for the bundle. Underneath instead, low throw. He's got a first down inside the 15 to Ben Cornelson, a senior from Shawnee, Kansas. And he wanted to go down to the middle of the field. His man was double covered.
He sure did. And now we got a dogfight. Turnovers are the great equalizer. And when you turn it over three times against a good football team, you got problems. Even though you were dominating and had a lead, you can't give the football up three times. And that's the difference in this football game right now in terms of Nebraska staying in it, because yards-wise, they were dominating.
Horn. In the eye behind Davies. Wide side of the field option. Back against the grain. It doesn't work for Lord. He is shut down. Basically no gain on the carry.
Boy, Kansas State gang tackling. You know, they don't want to put a teammate out the island. You know, because when you're out in an island against Lord, there's no Gilligan, there's no Marianne, no Professor. You're all by yourself.
Good play. Newman coming over there with Buell, the outside backer. It'll be second and 9, the ball at the 11-yard line.
I like the sugar huddle Nebraska's utilizing, you know, just a yard away from the football at the line of scrimmage.
Same combination in the backfield. David Horn trying to hop over his own man. That play was blown up early. Andrew Scholl was in the middle. Pierce cleaned up, but he had to hop over Andrew Scholl.
Andrew Scholl was the disruptor. He was the guy that got the penetration and made the pulling lineman jump over him and disrupted the whole play, and Pierce finished it.
Boy, tough day for this young man who 6 games ago joined the Huskers. He gave up his redshirt freshman year. And David Horn out of Central High School in Omaha, same high school where Gale Sayers came out of.
He's making his first cut in his own backfield every time. That's why he's -10.
Horn stays back there in the eye on 3rd and 9 for the 11. And Lord in trouble. Throws it away. Nobody in the neighborhood. And they're looking for a grounding call from Hal Dowden. It'll be 4th down and a field goal try coming up.
Terrence Newman came on the blitz, and Terrence Newman, I thought, was close to offsides, but he did not get in that neutral zone. And Jamal Lord, one thing he learned in the Texas game when he threw that interception at the end of the game. Don't turn it over in the red zone. He's in the red zone. Don't turn it over. Take a chance on an interception. Line up and at least get 3 points out of it.
It is going to be a 28, almost a 29-yard attempt for Brown, 2 for 2. This should be a chip shot.
Oh, he missed.
And he hits the upright. Do you believe it? Hits the far side upright.
The right upright. Amazing. It's a live ball. Oh, they're blowing it dead finally. They're blowing it dead.
Great. No points off the turnover. What a backbreaker for Nebraska. It looked like they were going to draw within 5 points.
Point.
Almost too easy that time for Josh Brown, but he hit the upright and the very top of it. He got plenty into it as it stays an 8-point deficit for the Nebraska Cornhuskers. That is only the fourth miss of the year for Josh Brown. He's been that good. Missed only three last year. Manning Sproles comprising the backfield. And on first down, Sproles negotiating his way across the 25 before Gross got him near the 27. What about the plant foot here, Dave Lapham?
Yeah, on this field turf, sometimes it's a little dicey. And watch Josh Brown's left foot, his plant foot, as he approaches the football. Plants that left foot, oop, gives on him a little bit, and he comes up close to the football and has to short leg it a little bit. As a result of that plant foot sliding, he pushes the ball out to the right. He skids up closer to the ball than he really wants to, pushes it right, and hits that right upright.
So often when it hits, though, and it hit the inside of the upright, it'll go through.
Right, and ricocheted back out instead of through. Look at the Nebraska. Boy, it's a fire drill, isn't it?
They're offside. Three down. And L. Roberson pulled down, and that could have been a flag out there, and it will be.
Yeah.
The man who threw it, the linesman who threw the offside, now throws his hat for the personal foul.
Right, he got Justin Smith, number 92, offsides, running down the line of scrimmage in the neutral zone as Nebraska's trying to get lined up properly. And then he has nothing left to throw. Can't take his pants or his shirt off. He throws his hat.
Don't go there.
He was busy. He was throwing everything.
Offsides on the defense. Dead ball, personal foul. Hit out of bounds on the defense. Be a 5-yard penalty and a 15. First down.
Well, Al Green, he makes the call on the offsides. And offsides is Justin Smith. Watch him, right here. He's running down the line of scrimmage. He's in the neutral zone. So he's offside. That's the flag.
Well, that looked like a drill.
It sure did. Now out of bounds. Here comes the late hit and the personal foul out of bounds as L. Roberson is taken down well out of bounds. And he doesn't have any flag left, so he gets rid of the hat. And he's taking it off piece by piece.
So, Al, let's stay together. Green out of Columbia, Missouri, makes the call.
Right. Makes two calls. And you know what? The kicking game has killed Nebraska. Missed field goal. And how about the blocked punt by Marcus Patton that was recovered and taken back for a touchdown by Jared Johnson of Kansas State? There's 10 points right there in the kicking game in a tightly contested 8-point game right now, 21-13 Kansas State.
Is this the best football weather we've seen this year? It is perfect out here today.
It really is.
Offsides on the defense is declined. Be a 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. Personal foul.
So 5.5 into the third quarter, and another look at the late hit.
Yeah,
it started in, it went out.
Yeah, let's see. Where's the first contact? He's in. That's where the first contact starts. Is this foot still in bounds? And now he's just going to finish the play. And I guess what you have to do is let him go. But boy, that's tough instincts to let a guy go when you started your tackling form. That's a tough call.
Nothing natural about trying to let him go. Roberson over the middle, wide open.
Oh.
It's Taco Wallace who separated from his, was that his helmet? No, the helmet stayed on. Yeah. Something flew. Josh Bullocks with the pop, but it was the
Bullocks
shoe.
Bullocks blew a tire.
Bullocks. I'm just glad that the wide receiver got up okay, Wallace.
I'm telling you, Bullocks, man, he's doing a pit stop. I mean, he came up there, just like NASCAR, the speed of this action right here. And Taco Wallace runs his cannon down the middle of the field. Bullocks, he'd already blown the tire, and man, he puts a smack on Taco.
Victor Mann, the only one in the backfield, now joined by Sproles. They give it to Mann. Good surge by the fullback inside the 30, down to the 29. Kansas State starting to control the line of scrimmage once again.
Well, they certainly are, and if not for the three turnovers, they'd be in total command of this football game. Now, they didn't, the turnover, the last turnover, fortunately for them, it wasn't costly because Josh Brown hit that right upright, but it cost them some field position, if nothing else.
Well, they're lucky because two of the three turnovers have not produced points for Nebraska.
But that blocked punt killed them.
There's Mann again. Why not try it? Man, he's close to a first down. Inside the 26-yard line. So if Nebraska cannot stop the run, it is going to be a real long day. Although the clock will move. Jim Knox, what's the latest?
All right, Joe, you see Mann's getting the bulk of the carries right now. That's because their number one fullback, Travis Wilson, remains in the locker room. Apparently that ankle injury is serious than expected. He remains in the locker room, so Mann carrying the football right now.
Yeah, sometimes, Knox, once the adrenaline rubs off, you know, Wilson realizes that he's injured more than he really thought he was because, you know, the hype of the game, you settle down on the sideline and say, man, you know what, this thing's killing me.
They do have the first down inside the 26. Roberson out of the edge. He's got room to run. Nice little pump. And takes a shot from Gross. Leaning for a first down to the 14. Yeah, we're looking forward to it. It's finally here, December 1st. ACC Sunday Night Hoops tip-off right here on Fox Sports Net. First matchup, well, the Wake Forest of the ACC is going to welcome in the Temple Owls of the Atlantic 10. So that is December 1st. It all starts with the college basketball tip-off show at 6 o'clock Eastern. Join us on that Sunday night.
Cheney's matchup zone in the first game. Having to figure out that matchup zone by Skip Prosser and his Wake Forest Demon Deacons.
Can only get easier.
Tough, yeah.
First and 10 inside the 14 of Nebraska on this drive that started back at the K-State 20. Deep set for Sproles. Contact. A little anxious.
Looked like Rude. Was rudely treated by L. Roberson as he got him offside by voice inflection. Rude was trying to time it and mistimed it. Skidded to the turf.
Offside.
Now this is good patience and poise by Leckie. They're all falling and he freezes. I mean, he doesn't move an inch. Talk about holding your water. That's a guy that's poised. Watch how poised this guy is. Because look at all the traffic happening. And he's just, look at him, he's a statue. I ain't moving. That snap count didn't happen yet. That's good poise.
3-5 takes it inside the 9. First and 5 for Kansas State. Sproles on the wide side. Cutting back inside. Wow. He's there. Touchdown Wildcats.
Man.
Just try to find this little guy slashing it back against the grain.
Yeah, that's the key. At 5'7", he hides behind those big offensive linemen. And then all of a sudden, he appears and he explodes. It's like magic. You know, hide. Where's the mascot? Then poof! Oh, there he is! Son of a gun. It's like magic. And by then, it's too late. Has his pad level lower than yours, takes you in the end zone. Great run.
Ream for the point after. And it completes an 80-yard drive for Kansas State, aided by a big personal foul call against Nebraska. Still running it efficiently once again. And now, a 15-point lead, K-State. Nebraska had a couple of opportunities, cashed in on one, but Darren Sproles gets it right back for Kansas State. And now, Wright kicks it away, a short one for Josh Davis. Across the 10, nice lane. Nifty move, beating men across the 40. Newman's got an angle. And that easily could be a flag as well, hitting him out of bounds, but Kansas State gets away with a break in front of their bench. Well, what a break for Kansas State after the Huskers couldn't capitalize on a turnover.
Yeah, Josh Brown's plant foot slips on him and he hits the right upright and they drive down the football field. Darren Sproles hides behind his lineman then pops into the end zone. DeMario Williams can't finish him before it's over the goal line. Big play.
It's already the third time in the first 8 minutes of the second half that Nebraska's had the ball to start with in Kansas State territory. As K-State took it 80 yards, didn't take long though.
Look at that, 25 yards and penalties on the drive
against
Nebraska. The 15-yarder
did hurt.
Yep.
Darren Dietrich back in there. The larger of the two backs between Horn and Dietrich. He gets close to 4, down to the 38. And let's face it, K-State did get a break. There could be a personal foul coming up. A
little woofing going on.
They got a break on the sideline when they Newman hit Josh Davis out of bounds.
And some serious woofing still going on.
Well, this is killing Nebraska.
And they just got to maintain their poise. They're frustrated right now of the big lineman for the Nebraska Cornhuskers and had too much to say and too much extracurricular going on. And it's going to cost them 15.
Dead ball, personal foul on the offense. 15-yard penalty, second down.
That negates the great field position they had.
The thing is, though, Joel, one of the big factors in this football game, Nebraska cannot run the ball against Kansas State at all. Kansas State's putting 8 and 9 in the box and taking away Nebraska's running game, and they're daring them to throw the football, and that's not Nebraska's game.
They have a little over 3 yards per pop, Dave. 22 carries for making 23 now for 78 yards.
That's the big key right here. Look at how many people are around the line of scrimmage. Look at all these guys up tight. Crowding it, daring them to throw.
That was a dead ball foul, so it's second down now after the game with about 3 or 4. And Lord has a man downfield, but it hangs up and it's intercepted.
I think they're going to call interference on him, though. He knocked him out of the way to catch the football.
Jordan went after the 50-50 ball with Wilson Thomas.
I think they're going to call Jordan for interference as Wilson Thomas got knocked out of the way by Jordan to catch it.
That's an interesting one, too.
I think the interference is going to go on the defense and nullify the turnover.
Pass interference against the defense. Be a 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
As Jordan's going to make a play on this football, Thomas is, he's got a right to the spot on the field as well. And the ball's thrown behind Thomas a little bit. Here comes Jordan closing on. He's going to knock Thomas out of the way. And boom, right through, knocks him out of the way, catches the football. That's interference.
So it paid off, after all is said and done for Nebraska, that it was underthrown.
Yeah. Threw behind him and a little short.
So the mark off. It'll take it down to the 38. And a first down now. So Nebraska in K-State territory. So much time left. 6:24 in the third quarter. Somewhere along the line, Nebraska's going to need a two-point conversion. In the eye, it's Horn instead of Dietrich. They're top heavy on the wide side of the field. Running the option that way, Lord. Horn on the outside, breaks the tackle, and he's got about 9 on first down. Caught by Thomas Houchin, the left end from behind, the junior from Sanger, Texas. This is the kid that can take it the distance, though. He's got the speed.
Yeah, and he's trying to get back to even Steven. Remember, his first 3 carries, he was minus 10. He picks up 9 there, so now on 4 carries, he's minus 1. Still on the wrong side of the ledger. He wants to get positive yards on those carries.
David Horn, considered by most services one of the top 5 running backs in the country in high school last year, weaving his way to a first down. Tumbles down to the 20-yard line. The arms of Terrence Newman.
Now he's out of the red and into the black. He's got the positive yards going. And he is a talented kid. He's got a little hesitation, stutter step, and great field vision. Does a good job of setting up his blockers.
So Nebraska starting to move people. Can it continue, though? They've got it at the 20. Keep Horn in the backfield in the eye. Davies, the fullback, stumbles his way into the 18. End of only 2. As Corey White got to him early, the senior, underneath tackle.
I think that's where it's all started. The fact that Kansas State has really stuffed Nebraska's running game for the most part starts with those 2 defensive tackles for Kansas State, Tank Reese and Corey White. They're doing a good job of holding down the middle of the line, letting the linebackers make plays. Apple a day keeps the doctor away for the boys there.
Third best in the nation, better than 100 so far today. Same combination in the backfield. Wide side call for Lord. Covering Davies, slicing through the great play by Pierce. Otherwise, he's got a first down. Pierce came out of nowhere as far as Jamal Lord is concerned.
Davies was very patient, bypassing one potential block defender to get the other one. They get tanked down, but look at the hustle. Not down long, and he's going to keep working down the field, making the play. Watch the patience by Davies. Bypass, get after another one. Pretty good job. Pierce is a great linebacker. Film study gives him great instinct.
How big is this third down play? Lord slowed down, diving close to the first down. Needed to go inside the 10. I believe he's shy by about a half a yard.
Boy, now do you go for the field goal? I go for the first down.
I don't think you have a choice.
You're down 15 points. And on the road, what does he think about on fourth down, Frank Solich?
We talked to Frank Solich earlier about these very situations, and they do go for it frequently on fourth.
Well, it depends a little bit where you're at on the field and what the situation is, but, you know, we've been going on fourth downs in certain situations, and certainly a lot of third down calls will be vital in this ball game to keep the drive alive.
9 of 19 on fourth downs, Lord, and he won't get there. What a play by Pierce again. The pitch was available. Lord wanted to hold on, though.
Penetration kills the option. Defensive linemen, linebackers have been in Nebraska's backfield with regularity. None bigger than that one. 12 tackles for loss this season by Terry Pierce. That may be the biggest. And all he does is just fill and run it down from behind. Fills inside of the tight end's block. Tight end can't get there in time to make any contact with him. Hasselbrook. And he gets inside and chases Lord down from behind. Again, this guy benches 520 pounds and runs a 4.640. He should be illegal.
2 years ago, the freshman defensive player of the year, the Big 12. And the biggest play of the day so far. Sproles, play goes low, and it's tough to find him. He stays low, like a water bug, down to the 20.
Turner Gill trying to keep his quarterback's head in the game. You know, Jamal, you know, you made plays for us all year long. Don't get down on yourself. Get your head up, Jamal. Get your head up. There's a lot of football left to be played. There's still 3 minutes to play in the third quarter. You got another entire quarter. Turner Gill, who's been there.
Well, we talked about it in the first half, though, sharing the football, like a good point guard in the basketball game.
Right, good decisions.
And he really hasn't distributed it that much on the option rolls. He's held it most of the time. Sproles, again, banging his way from maybe a yard to the 21. So it'll bring up a third and three. And the clock is going to eventually be the biggest enemy for Nebraska.
You look at Jamal Lord. Two times a quarterback has rushed for 200 yards in a single game. And they've had a lot of great quarterbacks here. You know, Tommy Frazier, Scott Frost, Eric Crouch. Who's done it? Lord. He's done it twice this year. He's the only quarterback in the storied history of this school to rush for 200 yards at the quarterback position in a single game. He's done it twice this year, so he's gotten them some places.
It'll be third and three from their own 21. Tight formation. And Roberson trying to bounce it on his own. Won't quit on the play, and he comes unbelievably close.
He does.
Did all of it by himself. He's short, though, I believe, by about a foot.
Boy, but he made something out of nothing, didn't he?
That's He's a not a big guy. He's only about 6 even, 205. They'll need a measurement.
That was a great 2-yard run right there. He made a lot of people miss and change directions about 3 times in a tight little area.
What Roberson has done better this year is his completion percentage. Last year, he had problems. He was only at about 40% on his attempts. This year, he stayed right around 50 or a little bit above 50% most of the season.
He's 53% on the year coming into today, and he's completed a high percentage today. He was 1 for 2 in the first half for over 40 yards in that one completion.
That's just like the game that they're going to play later, Texas Tech. Only throw 2 passes in the first half.
Two chain links short. And you got to punt it. You can't go here because if it doesn't work out, man. And they're going. They got confidence. He's gonna go for it. He's putting the big backfield in.
This is unreal.
Wow, he's going
but
for it.
Let's remind everybody, their defense is pretty sensational. Fourth best in total defense in the nation, giving up only 250 yards a game. Well, plus their success rate on fourth down this year, and they've succeeded again today. 3/4 of the time, they're 1 for 1 today, and they went with a silent count, you remember?
Yeah, well, they'll probably have the big backfield in. Nick, Vick, and Thick. Three big fullback-type guys in the backfield, and boy, look at this, it's a little wedge.
You got to believe it's going to be the sneak.
They're trying to draw him outside, and they drew Kelce off. They drew Kelce off, 3-5 yards.
Unbelievable. Yeah, I have a feeling they were never going to snap the football.
Probably not. And they were going to call, you know, let it melt down and call the timeout, but they got the guy who's been out 6 weeks, got him to jump.
And that lack of a rhythm and any kind of snaps over the last 6 has really killed Kelce.
Well, Kelce, somebody else jumped inside. Kelsey's peripheral vision saw his teammate jump inside, and then he totally jumped offside and made the contact. And Scott Shanley is the guy that Kelsey saw out of his peripheral vision jump inside, and he jumped outside.
Got to play smart. And that time Kansas State did. 90 seconds left in the quarter. Sproles. And boy, Wilson's in there, but hurting. The fullback was running behind the play to fake the reserve reverse.
Let's take a look at what Kelsey may have seen, the reason that he jumped. I don't think he was necessarily listening to the quarterback, but watch Stanley right here and right here jumping inside. That's what Kelsey saw. And his peripheral vision, he's looking into the football. He saw his teammates move, and he thought the ball might have moved. It didn't. And he's the one that made the contact to finish the play.
Nebraska didn't hurt themselves at all in the first half. Played it smart. Well, four times already, they have been their own worst enemy. Ooh, late for the draw. That's the first time we saw Roberson wait that long and make the poor decision. Otherwise, the quarterback draw has been a little bit quicker.
Yeah.
He's recognized the pressure from the outside.
Yeah, he has done a better job in the decision-making process executing the option than Jamal Lord has done today. There's no question about it. I think Kansas State, though, has run more looks at Jamal Lord than Nebraska has at L. Roberson.
They don't have to run in their play if they don't want to. Play clock has not even started, and they won't. That'll be the final snap. So at the end of three, still, Kansas State 28-13. You're watching College Football Saturday, presented by Kyocera on Fox Sports Net. Love me when I'm big punt block towards the tail end of the first half gave Nebraska, or Kansas State rather, a 21-3 lead at the time. And the key, though, the rushing yardage. Difference in rushing yardage. And now third and 11 for Roberson for the first snap of the fourth. Looking deep down the middle.
Oh.
Right in the noggin of his diving wide receiver, Taco Wallace. I think it got to the cage before it got to the hands.
I think you're right. And if L could have gotten a little bit more elevation on this throw, he throws a seed, and it's sinking. It's a sinker. And Taco goes down to try to get his hands underneath it and just can't quite come up with the football. A little more accurate throw. He was so wide open, would have been preferable.
So DeJuan Gross, he could make it very interesting on this.
They come. Ooh.
They almost got to him. A high one. Great hang time by Travis Brown. Gross trying to chase him down as Newman. He's across the 40 with great field position. So a good return by DeJuan Gross. Plenty of time left for Nebraska, but they're running out of possession. So they better capitalize on this. They may get two more in the fourth. College Football Saturday presented by Kyocera. And don't forget later this afternoon, Big 12 North Showdown, Seneca Wallace and Iowa State. Going to Boulder to take on the nation's leading rusher, Chris Brown, of the 17th-ranked Colorado Buffaloes. Bill Land, Gary Reasons with the call. Folsom Field in Boulder. Along the Rockies, that's Iowa State, Colorado. 7 o'clock Eastern, right here on Fox Sports Net. And Chris Brown, of course, one of the Heisman Trophy candidates on top in the rushing department, close to 162 a game.
And that's hard to do in the Big 12. I mean, you know, there's a lot of good defenses against the run. Chris Brown, physical, punishing-style runner that finishes every single opportunity. You got to... injured Nebraska Cornhusker on the sideline. Gross is on his backside, and boy, they'd hate to lose Gross. There he is getting some attention. Hopefully just had the wind knocked out of him. We'll see.
Newman landed on him at the tail end of the play. Newman didn't quit on it. He was the first one down there.
Maybe he fell on the ball.
He was in hot pursuit.
He may have fallen on the ball and had the wind knocked out of him, or hopefully it's nothing more than that. Doesn't look like it's anything. And the way he's kind of trying to arch his back, it looks like maybe hopefully just trying to get some air into his lungs. And he goes airborne, and boom, he might have fallen right on the football as Newman fell on top of him and taken the air out of himself.
He hurdles Shull, and then...
boom, right on the ball.
And then he's gasping for breath.
And that's a bad feeling. Boy, when you have the breath knocked out of you, you think you're going to die. I mean, you'd think that you're never going to take another one.
So Nebraska, great field position again at their own 40-yard line. Their previous three drives in the second half have all started in K-State territory, but they only scored on one of the three. Horn in the eye. Running the option instead of throw. And wide open.
Oh!
And dropped. Do you believe David Horn couldn't hang on?
Oh, my goodness.
Incredible. Well, the penalties have hurt. I said they've been their own worst enemy in the second half, and it continues for the Huskers.
Well, they tried to do the play-action pass to get the ball down the middle of the field to Harrion. He was covered well. Harrion, watch Harrion come off the line of scrimmage. He's covered well. Horn out of the backfield, though, they lose track of. Harrion releases. There he goes. Here comes Horn. They forget all about Horn. Harrion's covered. He goes to Horn. Oh, can't catch it.
Now Dietrich. Across the 42 to the 43. It'll bring up a third and seven. Tank Reese got to him. Well, let's see what happened at the tail end of the play to David Horn.
Boy, he comes out of there, and David Horn is so wide open, he can almost fair catch this football. He adjusts to it and takes his eyes off it just a little too soon.
Now he's got to get his hands out.
Man.
Away from his body, too.
Yeah, the ball hit his shoulder pads. You have to extend your hands and catch it out in front of your body. Anytime you let the ball eat your shoulder pads up, you get trouble because it can deflect.
They're looking at Henry Bryant, the senior from Boca Raton, who had a big play and lost his helmet in the process in the first half for a sack.
Well, you look at that catch or missed opportunity for catch by Horn. Field goal hits the upright.
Block punt, fail on fourth.
Don't take advantage of opportunity wide open. Boy, it's, you know, you're plus three in the turnover department. That's the only reason you're in this football game at all, and good to see him up and getting off the field under his own power.
We talked about it at the very top of the telecast, how much this game means to the Little Apple. They were trounced for so many years by Nebraska. Now they split the last four. Two cities are only 2 hours apart, but the gap is certainly narrowed in the two programs. Darren Diedrich, the only one in the backfield. Now, can they negotiate a third and seven?
Watch Harrion on the backside here.
Only one for 11 on third down. Try so far today. It almost looks like they wanted to set up a screen. Forget about it. The sack all the way back at the 30-yard line. A huge loss of about 13 yards. Getting there, Eric Everly.
Yeah, Everly, the artist. And he was totally... He painted a great picture on that one. It was meet at the quarterback. I mean, there was total breakdown in the pass protection for Lord, and Everly got the first hit.
Going back deep. It's going to be Derek Evans, a junior from Denver, not Terrence Newman. And a wobbler, returnable type if he can get to it. Evans.
Whoa, crap.
And now they took his helmet off. That'll be a penalty against Nebraska. Scott Shanley may be a little frustrated.
That'll be 15. I mean, that if he grabbed the face mask and pulled the helmet off, that's a personal foul. That's 15. And he did. Yanked his helmet right off his head. Boy, you can get some serious neck injuries doing that.
So K-State, great shape field position-wise.
Personal foul, face mask against the kicking team. Be 15 yards from the end of the run. First down.
That is going to take it close to Nebraska territory. Not 2 minutes gone by, and everything working the Wildcats' way. They look for their third consecutive win at home over the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Football Saturday presented by Kyocera welcomes you once again to Manhattan, Kansas. Big 12 college football at Kansas State University as the number 11 ranked Wildcats are dominating the Nebraska Cornhuskers, especially on the ground, where Nebraska usually takes care of business. They have been shut down today. And the tight end floats in the flat for a big gain. Thomas Hill breaking tackles to the 25. Good sell by L. Roberson on the first down.
Boy, if you're a linebacker from Nebraska, what do you do here? Eventually, they go to the tight end, but watch this. This misdirection, L comes out here. I mean, it's a fire drill. And now the tight end releases, and just a great misdirection, naked bootleg for the quarterback eventually to the tight end after he slow blocks. Tremendous execution of a well-conceived play.
This drive started at the Nebraska 48. First time Kansas State, believe it or not, has started a drive in Husker territory. Sproles on his way. Look out. This could do it. Touchdown, Kansas State.
Boy, the
L. Roberson. Ooh. 25 yards. And nobody close that time, Dave.
He was like Moses and the Red Sea parted. And L. Roberson said, I'm taking it to the house. I mean, he would have scored in touch football. Nobody laid a fingernail on L. Roberson. I mean, you talk about a cavity, it was the Grand Canyon.
It comes with 12:45 left in the fourth quarter. Ream for the point after. And that could certainly seal the deal for Kansas State. Too easy for L. Roberson, going through a huge hole. Maybe too much for Nebraska to overcome. L. Roberson doing it again just before we went away with a 25-yard touchdown run. As Jarrett Wright will kick it away for Kansas State, a dominating performance on the ground today. They haven't had to put it in the air at all. Josh Davis waits. Does he want to bring it out? 2 yards in, he will. They set up the wall. Davis only out of the 20, and a flag at the tail end of the play where they may have caught the grill. The cage of Josh Davis as he went down. Now, the deception by L. Roberson in the backfield has been sensational all day. We saw it on the pass, as there's going to be a hold instead. We saw it on the pass to Thomas Hill. It continued on the touchdown run, where he faked the handoff early. Now let's take a look at that again and how it opened up, and maybe the biggest hole of the day.
Well, watch the blocking here. It's going to ball it all up. But watch Pippins right here. He gets frozen. He doesn't even know where the ball is. I mean, you talk about the Red Sea parting in L. Roberson. That thing was 18,000 yards wide. And watch Gerald Pippins, number 31. He fakes. He gets fooled. He's looking at the fullback. Here's L. Roberson. Here's the football. He's watching the fullback. And L. did now. Nobody's got the quarterback. Oh, too easy.
From the 10, it'll be the toss to Horn. And barely taken down. In the secondary, they get to him. It was Rashad Washington. Otherwise, David Horn's down the sideline. Rarely do you see somebody do what L. Roberson has done to Nebraska today. And the most recent scoring drive is now put Roberson into the record books here at Kansas State with a new single game rushing record for quarterbacks. 212 yards, and that's the fourth best by anybody for the Wildcats.
And three touchdowns to boot.
Holding it high for a first down, the fullback, Judd Davies. He ended up high like it was a precious baby.
Really? You know, Joel, we've seen, what is it about quarterbacks, option quarterbacks, and us? I mean, we saw Jamal Lord set the record against Texas, 234 yards for Nebraska at the quarterback position. Now today, L. Roberson goes for 212 against Nebraska, setting a record for quarterbacks rushing. Amazing.
And now Nebraska needs three touchdowns, and in one of those three, they need a two-point conversion, trailing 35-13. They run the option to the wide side. Lord, chopped down. What an open field tackle. Exceptional play by Randy Jordan. And he got off his man in a hurry.
The inside-out pursuit was fantastic. And Jamal Lord just can never get in sync. Watch the pursuit here by Kansas State. Looks like there's a big cavity. Watch these guys close on the football. Here's the hit. And that's fantastic team defense. Everybody's got their gap control. Nobody's knocked on the ground. Everybody's flying to the football, gang tackling big time.
Gain of only two. Horn again. into the congestion. They've got him after a gain of only two more. Up to the 29, Brian Hickman stopping him. The outside linebacker from Mesquite, Texas. So Kansas State has pretty much had it their way today. They have had only two losses this year, and don't forget, they are 7 points away from a perfect season. Three-point loss we did, Dave, to Texas. And early in the year, they lost at Boulder, 35-31.
Right, and that loss is the potential tiebreaker as they win today. If, in fact, Iowa State were to upset Colorado, Colorado still have an edge because of that 35-31 victory head-to-head.
Nebraska uses their first timeout of the second half and stops it with 10:31 to play. So the importance, we talked about it earlier, for L. Roberson. Would they have an opportunity to go to the Big 12 title game? Starting the day a game behind Colorado, who matches up later tonight against Iowa State at 7 o'clock Eastern on Fox Sports Net. They need help, though. Don't forget, they need two straight losses by Colorado because right. Colorado owns the tiebreak yeah. in that four-point win. So they need Colorado to lose tonight and then lose next week at Nebraska. Don't forget what happened to Nebraska and Boulder last year. Nebraska's going to be ready for that game. Later tonight, right after Iowa State and Colorado, the NFL show, all presented by the U.S. Postal Service. Get your fix a day early. The goose is loose in his old neighborhood in Baltimore with Tommy Davidson. Don't miss Saragusa's six-pack. Tony is 9-2-1, believe it or not, over the last 2 weeks.
I want to see that goose leave the ground. I want to see that goose get airborne.
That goose does not fly.
That goose, no.
Look at your gander, though.
That goose is loose, Bo. I'll tell you, he's a loose goose.
Now, second and about four. Make it third and about four. Lord.
Uh-oh.
Too tall. Hassebrek was there. Way too tall. And throwing against the grain, it's tough for a guy who's not a natural thrower to begin with to go that way, isn't it, Dave?
It really is. And what Kansas State has done is taken Nebraska out of their offense. I mean, they've shut the running game down. And Jamal Lord, you know, he's only gotten one ball to his tight end. That's where you'd think he'd go at the football the most in that play action. It was to Herrien for 28 yards. Only 11 yards per completion to his wide receivers. Only 7 completions on the day, and they've thrown it a lot.
Now Newman, a little icing on the cake. No, they'll keep it away from the boundary, out of bounds. Great field position. Poor Kansas State once again. Who would have believed, though, that Kansas State could control this game with L. Roberson going only 4 for 7? They haven't required the passing game today.
Right, they've thrown the ball when they wanted to. Nebraska has thrown the ball because they've had to. The reason? Kansas State has run the football at will. Nebraska has not been able to run it at all. And when you're one-dimensional because you can't, you know, Nebraska's not doing either phase of it well. Kansas State is dominant in the running game, and when you're good at one phase of it, the other phase becomes easier.
So Nebraska with the loss today, and if it stays the same way, they will fall to 7-5. They'll fall to 3-4 in Big 12 play. And then the discussion comes up. They're already bowl eligible.
Right.
It'll be interesting to see what happens after the game against Colorado at home next week. Victor Mann, Darren Sproles in the backfield.
That's 2 weeks.
Exactly. Thanks. Sproles carries him for about 4.
The ball carries number 43.
6 more Darren needed for a first down. And while we're talking about down the road for Nebraska, what's down the road for us on Fox Sports Net? Well, next Saturday, Apple Cup game, and it is a serious sight. It's so much fun. Been to the one in Seattle. This one is in Pullman. You got to get loose in the Palouse. That's number 3, Washington State. Major championship implications. Forget about the Pac-10 title.
Right.
What about a BCS and an opportunity to go to the national championship game?
I like
that's also at stake.
I like their little salty quarterback, Gesser.
And Arizona State, Arizona. And Dave, we're going to be on the 30th on a Saturday afternoon.
State championships everywhere.
You got it. Oklahoma, Oklahoma State. Rare toss. There goes Sproles. Good chase. Nice chase down out of the secondary, making the play. It was Jarrell Phillips. Jim Knox, what's going on downstairs?
Hey, Joel. DeJuan Gross still remains on Nebraska's bench. Keep in mind, he came out a couple of series ago. Really took a shot. Guys not only got the breath knocked out of him, they were looking at his jaw. Also, he lost a contact on the play. Right now, he remains on Nebraska's bench.
And he does claim that record, though, that Johnny Rogers set back in 1972. It was Johnny Rogers' Heisman Trophy season.
Man, when you get a contact knocked out of your head, though, that's serious collision. Man, oh, man.
On third, less than a yard.
That happened to me on Monday Night Football, Joel. We're playing the Miami Dolphins. I'm covering it. I'm in the wedge.
On the offense. Returning the kickoff. Still third down.
You lost a contact?
I lost both. Ed Newman, the big all-pro guard for the Miami Dolphins, is coming down like crazy. He's running like crazy. And we have a heck of a contact in the collision in the wedge. We both go down sideways. I get up and, man, I can't see. He knocked me senseless. I realized both my – I was wearing hard contact lenses, not the soft ones. They both popped right out of my eyes. I mean, on that collision.
Glad it was all that popped out.
Oh, my goodness. My brain was rattled. I was a hurting unit.
Top team on third down conversions in the Big 12. Tries to get a little more than five, almost six. And on the edge, Roberson should be able to get it. And he will, by about a half yard. Flag at the end of the play.
Yeah, I wonder if there was a hold on the edge as L. Roberson cut back inside. I didn't see any face mask or anything, so they got the illegal block in the back. And I think they caught the big tight end, Thomas Hill. He's hard to miss. He is a big man, 6'5", 260.
Illegal block in the back on the offense, 10-yard penalty. Well, repeat third down.
I get a kick out of you saying that as we'll take a look at it. You're not exactly dainty yourself.
No. But watch Mr. Hill. You know, he's hustling. I mean, he's working down the football field. He's presenting himself as a receiver. Now his quarterback's running, and right there the push in the back is what's called as the tackle's trying to be made. So if he had turned around a little quicker and got his hands in the framework of the body, in the front of the body, instead of, you know, once you push in the back numbers, you're in trouble.
But once again, Nebraska, with the clock moving down to the 8-minute mark. Frustrated. They do not have the football, and they need three touchdowns. Roberson down the middle, and Terry stopped for some reason. There's a flag, and boy, did he bait that defensive back into that one.
Ricketts.
Pat Ricketts ran up his back, and it wasn't a catchable ball to begin with. This is one you put away.
And
he did stop.
Yeah. I wonder if he stopped because Ricketts grabbed him. I wonder if he was helped in his stop. And not happy at all is Bland. And he's saying, you know what, we can't catch any break here.
Pass interference against the defense. 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
And that was third and 10. Third and 10, you have that interference call. And you pick up 15, you get another first down by penalty. And now Nebraska is starting to get penalties at crucial times that have hurt them. During the course of the season, that is something that Frank Solich has been disappointed about. Bill Snyder's team, other than three turnovers, they're minus three in the turnover department, still up 23 on Nebraska. Who would have thunk that?
Not that Nebraska's going to be coming back, but now Kansas State can just run out the clock. Keep it on the ground, chew up another few minutes. Sproles circling to join Mann in the backfield, but it'll be Victor Mann. Simple dive for a yard to the 44. College Football Saturday presented by Kyocera. We continue from Wagner Field in Manhattan. Maybe the prettiest football Saturday that we have seen this season. We've had some beauties, but this one about 50 degrees at kickoff. Just a classic setting for college football.
And, you know, it seemed like Nebraska today, Joel, decided to take Sproles out of the running game, and Roberson benefited. The reason they wanted to take Sproles out, he had tied a school record, six straight 100-yard rushing games in jeopardy of, he could have said it today, it doesn't look like he's going to be able to.
Sproles, don't talk too soon.
Yeah.
He's got a first down to the 33. Trying to catch him. I think you need a rope.
Yeah. He's a water bug, a June bug for sure. He's got seven 100-yard games this season. That ties a record that he's very proud of, obviously. Josh Scobie set it last year. He tied that record. And in the six straight 100-yard games, Isaac Jackson set it back here in 1973 at Kansas State. I played with Isaac Jackson in the blue-gray game. And here is Sproles tying his record.
First and 10 from the 33. Sproles enveloped, making the stop there. It was Gabungo.
He will envelop
that's
you.
About it. He's, as you said, he's a foot taller. He's 100 pounds more. Now, here's what I get a kick out of. This is the fourth largest in K-State history. They expanded the stadium a few years ago once Bill Snyder got here. Good move economically. But nobody's left. And it goes back to the big brothers to the north. And these people here in Manhattan feel that they don't get the respect that they deserve the way their program has been in recent years. This is going to be the third time over the last 5 years they have beaten Nebraska. So now about a second and eight situation. Offside Kabungo. Three down. You could just see the big guy crawl out of the stands.
I think this, if I recall, this is the first time since 1968 Nebraska wasn't ranked.
November 9th, 1968 was the last time they faced Kansas State.
Unranked.
Largest margin of victory, it's a 22, at least for Kansas State, was 27.
Offsides, on the defense, 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
I told you it was a nice day. It's not that nice.
No, those guys are doing a science fair project or something.
Oh, no, they got a lot of antifreeze work.
Yeah, I mean, they're seeing what the freezing point is here in Manhattan. That's got to be, they got to be a little bit chilly. Got to be.
They've been up all night. Those were the guys we were looking at earlier. Yeah. That slept outside. Like it was a World Series game, getting ready.
Got to get them a little hot cocoa, a little hot chocolate.
Now, second and short. Sproles carrying the man on his back close to the first down to 23, Trevor Johnson. So Kansas State, with only two losses, enhancing their bowl picture and the potential to move into the top 10 this week. At least they should. They have been real convincing today in the trenches.
In 7-1, it looks like they're going to finish 7-1 at home. And the only loss, like we talked about earlier, basically a last play loss to Texas. Blocked field goal. Texas beats them by 3 points.
So now a little more than 5.5 to play. It'll be a first down for the Wildcats. And Roberson reminding James Terry where he should be in the set. On Taco Wallace's side. Good reason. It was his play. Corner of the end zone, batted away. Good play downfield by Pat Ricketts.
Hey, you'd think if he was the primary, he'd know where to line up, huh?
Now, what about the Big 12 as they get ready to go bowling and the projections?
Boy, it's some nice, some interesting matchups there. Oklahoma, Notre Dame. How about that potential in the Orange Bowl?
That'll be fun.
If Texas can work their way back up into the BCS, Kansas State has a shot at the Cotton Bowl. The Alamo Bowl matched up against the Golden Gophers. Iowa State, Boise State, Nebraska against Ole Miss. Eli Manning, Archie's son. How about that matchup? Colorado, USC, a rematch. Colorado beat him during the, Kansas State beat him in the regular season. Colorado lost to him, didn't they?
Roberson again making the most out of the situation, and he's close to another first down. He had to take it inside the 13. That's exactly where he went. I think he's got it. Yes. So it continues for L. Roberson. He's 4 of 8 passing for 92 yards. That's an afterthought today for him, though. Running the football, how about 29 carries for 228 yards?
Boy, 29 carries. Talk about durability. Talk about conditioning. Talking about finishing. You know, the record Jamal Lord set, 30 carries against Texas A&M, was a record for Nebraska at the quarterback position carrying the football. Roberson has set the yardage record, 29 carries. He's got to be record-setting there as well.
There goes Bowles. Good night. Darren Sproles with a touchdown.
Jeez. Remember I talked about his acceleration, 0 to 60, about as fast as anybody in college football. Watch this acceleration. Gets the handoff. He's gone. Nobody's catching him. He put it in overdrive quickly. That's 0 to 60 in a heartbeat. I mean, that's slow motion, and he looked faster than I could ever hope to run.
I hope you don't play video games. You could become violent for the point after. Joe Ream. And averaging 46 a game. Second highest scoring team of the nation, K-State. Not far away from that total. College Football Saturday on Fox Sports Net, brought to you by Kia Sierra, one company, countless solutions. By Nissan and your Nissan dealer. By Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. And by Wendy's. If you want to eat great even late, remember, Wendy's rules the night. Right now, in Aggieville, it's only the Wildcats ruling anything. They are dominating Nebraska, winning by 29 points. And like everything else, it works for Kansas State. So Nebraska with the ball at their own 20. And Sproles also having a very big day on the ground with 86 yards on only 19 carries. Well, they chewed up what they wanted to was the clock. That's all they needed to do. Took better than 5 minutes off it to make sure that Nebraska was not going to have a prayer. And then added the score from Darren Sproles. But there were a couple of sequences early in the second half where Nebraska could have gotten right back into the game. In fact, they were down 21-13. And another sack of Lord, but the turning point, and after turnovers.
Yeah, Brown misses the field goal, hits the right upright as his plant foot slips, and Darren Sproles makes him pay, finishing the opportunity with a touchdown. He appears before your very eyes for six. Then the fourth down play. Terry Pierce makes a big, big play on Lord. Finished with another touchdown. Boom, there goes Sproles up the gut. And it's all Kansas State after that missed field goal hit the upright. At that point, it was, what was it, an eight-point game, I believe?
21-13, 10 minutes left in the third quarter. Right. And since that point, we've had an 8-yard touchdown run, which you saw by Sproles, a 25-yarder by Roberson, and now a 12-yard touchdown run by Sproles. So that's 21 straight.
Now, Nebraska, I mean, Kansas State is minus -3 in the turnover department and up 42-13. That's how much they've dominated this football game. You don't beat Nebraska by 29 minus -3.
Diedrich looking like a plotter because of the good defensive work. Tank Reeves. Now, how the Aggies handling Prosperity after beating Oklahoma? Brad Smith and Missouri. Boy, he's a great quarterback. Now, Oklahoma State, that's a shock. The Cowboys on the road to Kansas.
Yeah, real shocker. How about Rock Chalk Jim?
Final 4 minutes of play. And a low throw from Jamal Lord. Jim Knox, you have really been waiting patiently.
Oh, thank you, Joe. I tell you what, really making a difference today on that Kansas State defense. We saw him make a tackle a couple plays ago. Tank Reese, number 30 of K-State, 5'11", 280 pounds. Guys, he squats 911 pounds. Joel, that's like Dave Lapham on your back, I guess, about 3.5 times. That's 3.5 Dave Laphams, you consider last night's seafood buffet.
Yes.
You know what, though, guys? His legs are only 12 inches long, so he didn't have to bend very far.
We went to a seafood buffet last night, and Lapham came back with prime rib.
He's strong.
Lord in trouble, on his way down. Guess who cleaned up? The tanker. Shull held him up. And the senior from Auburndale, Florida.
You know, that's a tank that can move. Tank can, you know, you talk about change of direction by running backs. Look at Tank. He's got his pad level lower than you. That's not a normal tank. I mean, a tank can't make a quick left turn like that and finish a quarterback. That's a special tank.
Are you vertically challenged when you're 5'11", 290 pounds?
Yeah, gravity kills you. Gravity kills you.
Larson, he's been busy. And that's maybe his best of the day. Over-the-shoulder catch, Terrence Newman.
Oh, what are you doing? That's a potential injury there. You don't leave your feet like that.
At the 30-yard line, the Wildcats get it back with 2:55 to play. And we remind you, the executive producer of Fox Sportsnet is Bill Borson. Coordinating producers of College Football Saturday, Roy Hamilton and Gary Garcia. Today's game produced by Mike Helling and directed by Ken Fouts. College Football Saturday studio show produced by Lloyd Maxson and directed by Joe Wood. Senior Vice President of the Field Operations, Andrea Berry. Vice President of the Field Operations is Karen Newman. Victor Mann, Darren Sproles back out there. Bill Snyder leading by the largest, right now would be the largest margin of victory ever. Kansas State over Nebraska.
And Leckie right here is the leader up front, the war daddy. And that offensive line for Kansas State has done a great job. I mean, they sealed Nebraska off. They pinned Nebraska defensive linemen and linebackers consistently, and Leckie's the leader. Has had a heck of a football game.
Called it second and 10. Just shy of the 31-yard line. Sproles. Slight kick out. Doing it on his own.
There's 100.
Goodbye. He's gone. They celebrate in Manhattan.
Darren Sproles just broke two records right there. Seven straight 100-yard games, broke Isaac Jackson's record. Eight 100-yard games on the season, broke Josh Scobie's record. That's a very memorable run for an unbelievably talented football player.
I told you when you brought it up, I said, don't talk too soon.
I'm telling you, boy. He went to the house quickly. That acceleration, he didn't have to have the rack and pinion steering. He just accelerated and stayed the course, boy.
It was 21-3 at the half. It is now 49-13 after the 70-yard run by Darren Sproles.
Wow.
Blowing it wide open. Happy trails.
Is that Noxie?
Until we meet again.
Is that Noxie up there?
It wouldn't shock me.
Man.
It would
Who
not
is that
surprise
masked man?
Me.
I'm thinking that's Jim Knox.
These stands are swaying right now. As far as Kansas State is concerned, this is their chief rival. It's not the Jayhawks. It's the Huskers. And they are enjoying this Saturday afternoon in Manhattan. It'll be the biggest win ever by Kansas State, the margin of victory at least, as Davis takes it, then takes a shot across the 55. The biggest win, margin of victory-wise, for the Wildcats. And little doubt about our player of the game, our Dr. Pepper player of the game, L. Roberson. The junior from Baytown, Texas, Dave.
L. Roberson, Joel, hung the big L on Nebraska, meaning loss. Nebraska on the road. Only won one game this year on the road. Down at Texas A&M, they've lost six on the road.
That is the second best rushing day ever. Running back, quarterback, you name it, at Kansas State. He's got 228. Sproles has 155. And Horn dropped. Not too kind. And you're trailing by, 36 points now? How about, though, overall, 57 carries, 415 yards rushing.
Wow.
And you're facing... It's not Eastern Washington, it's Nebraska.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And Nebraska had been playing the run well coming into this football game. I mean, Texas couldn't run the ball at all against Nebraska. Chris Sims threw it for 419. And, boy, Kansas State just took them apart on the ground today.
Bill Jones and the guys standing by, Big 12. Postgame report coming up next. Nice play. Henry Bryant again.
Well, let's look at these two great rushers today. L. Roberson, watch the move he puts on Justin Bland. Whoop, see ya, froze him. And L. Roberson takes the house for 91 yards. Watch the move Sproles puts on right here on Turpin. Whoop, and he goes to the house. The difference in this football game, he made a few guys miss. The difference is making somebody miss and then gang tackling. Kansas State gang tackled Lord and company. Kansas State's running backs made people miss in the open field.
This should be the final snap of the game. Fortunately for everybody involved. And it will be after they stop it and move the chains on the first down to Ben Cornelson. So Nebraska will get ready for Colorado. They owe Colorado. And don't forget, 7 o'clock Eastern tonight. You think the K-State coaches will be watching this game just a little bit. Iowa State at Folsom Field.
That's mandatory. Mandatory viewing.
Way past Wilson Thomas with a shove to the back of the D-back. 19 seconds left. And what a crowning moment for Bill Snyder's program to have come this far in 14 seasons. His third win against Nebraska's third consecutive here in Manhattan.
It's incredible when you think again. His football team was -3 today. That's the one thing he's going to talk about. Guys, we can't turn the football over three times and not get it once and hope to win football games like we did today. But they ran it.
back down to the play. Hassebrecht.
Uh-oh.
Gatorade shower. I don't think they have to worry like the Kentucky sideline against LSU.
No, and Bill Snyder, he's totally unsuspecting. He has no clue. You know, he's still focused, still into the game. And they're plotting their course.
A bowl game, let's face it, it's a big one. It's a reward. But for Bill Snyder and his staff, this game is everything.
Just an outstanding performance in every phase of his football team today. Offense, you run for 415 against Nebraska, you're getting it done. Defense, shut Nebraska's running game down like you did, you're getting it done.
And how sweet it is, Dave, as you know, playing college football. It comes on Senior's Day.
Yeah. Oh, it's a memory. It's a memory. And, Bill, you're about to get wet. About to get wet, Bill Snyder.
Will this be the final snap? Lord, and almost intercepted by Newman. 9 seconds remaining. I don't know if I want to do that to Bill Snyder, though.
You know, it's a chilly day to get wet, too. Man, it's cold out there. And they got him. Here they come. Oh, they got their opening. Oh, and they said, no, let's take it back. I wonder if they're being told to don't do it. Don't do it. They're saying stay off the field. Bill Snyder just patrolling the sideline.
I think they've been discouraged.
I think the assistant said, no go, Jose. Don't do it.
Just what we needed. More flags. It comes with 4 seconds left on the board. And I talked about the rushing yardage for Kansas State today.
Here they come. Got another opening. And they're being waved off again.
False start on the offense. 5 yard penalty.
You look at now Barnett is blocking out the sun, not just the Gatorade bucket.
You know what? Even though they're up so big, they don't want to do it because of what happened last week with LSU and Kentucky. Don't want to douse the coach before the game's over. And they're going to get him.
Should be the final snap. Good Lord.
Oh, Bill's wet.
And that'll do it.
Oh, baby. They waited until the last play.
Wait a minute. Stop everything. Bill Snyder is smiling.
They had to wait to that last play because that LSU-Kentucky deal did not want to douse him early. He'll take it, though.
36-point victory for number 11 Kansas State should propel them into the top 10. Where their demolition of Nebraska this afternoon. Their final home game of the season, Senior Day. And it will not be forgotten by those 27 seniors.
Boy, you talk about running the football and stopping the run. That was a clinic today. I tell you, Knox, you better bring a towel out there to talk to Coach Snyder. Maybe some shampoo and soap would be in order.
Let's head down and join Jim Knox. Knoxie.
All right, Coach, you got to be extremely pleased. What a complete domination today, especially the running game. L. Roberson, 228 yards rushing. Darryl Sproles over the 100-yard mark for eighth time this season.
Yes.
Okay, are you happy about that?
Well, we're pleased that we won the ball game and pleased that we played so well in so many aspects of the game, which we really did.
Defensively.
Nebraska's not a bad football team. They maybe didn't play as well as they have in the past, but we played pretty well today, and I'm pleased with our youngsters.
Defensively, how'd you slow down Nebraska's rushing attack? Kept them less than 100 yards today.
Well, we've always played relatively well against the run, and you know that today wasn't any different. You have to be out of the way, or you're going to get hurt. Anyway, thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you, Coach. Back to you, Joe.
Noxie looks like Sproles. You can't find him in there.
I thought Noxie couldn't moonwalk until today. Now I know he can. Don't forget, later tonight, 17th-ranked Colorado taking on Iowa State. That's at 7 o'clock Eastern on Fox Sports Net. Coming up for most of you, it's going to be the Big 12 postgame report. Bill Jones in the studio with the rest of the guys. College Football Saturday has been a presentation of Fox Sports Net. Now for Dave Lapp and Jim Knox, I'm Joel Myers. Thanks for joining us, everyone. Complete effort by Kansas State. So long from Manhattan.